Right. Right. Anyway.
Hi.
Good morning. This is the Opie and Anthony program.
That's what they call it.
Well, it's a virus, the ONA virus, spreading across America. This virus much more effective than the bird flu.
Wow. Spreading among people faster.
Because people are actually getting the ONA virus.
Yeah.
No one's getting the fucking bird flu.
There's
Let's
a couple of people.
Down.
They get them from the birds, though, in, like, Vietnam and shit. The guys that work in the chicken coops over there. Breathing in dusty, dried-up bird shit. That's how you get it. And they're getting it. That's it.
The bird flu.
It's Vietnam. Oh, it's always Southeast Asia, some of that shit. That's where the bird flu comes from.
You know, we got to get the piece that 60 Minutes did on the bird flu.
Yeah.
Because they were talking about the one guy that's in charge of the bird flu over there in
There's
Vietnam.
There's one guy.
And they have like a bird flu hotline. And it's his personal cell phone.
Hotline.
That's the real problem. They're just not organized over there to take care of a pandemic.
Pandemic.
A pandemic.
Well, apparently the bird flu can't go from people to people. That's the thing that's keeping it from being a big deal. They say once it can, once, you know, some guy with the bird flu sneezes and he's able to give it to someone else, then it's over, Johnny. We got to build a rocket and get off the fucking planet. That's how they're panicking.
That's how
about
every
this
disease
whole.
Is like.
Yeah. Exactly.
That's how every disease scares you, if you can catch it from somebody else.
Once you catch it from somebody else. I believe once it can be passed human to human, we could see an increase in cases. No shit.
Of course, nigga.
Who's
touching birds?
Right now they're getting it from birds. When was the last time you even got near a fucking bird?
A live bird.
Yeah.
Only dead birds, nigga. I eat chicken, you know, dead chicken, but, you know, I hope it's not bird flu and dead chicken. Then we in.
If every bird had it. A lot of people still wouldn't get it. You have to be near a bird that has the fucking bird flu.
And some bird that goes to Asia. Like the Asian cuckoo.
Some fucking bird we never get around here because they're talking about,
well, the migratory habits of this bird could bring it close to our nation.
No, it can't.
And, you know, our pigeons, we got the filthiest birds in history, so we don't get anything from our filthy-ass pigeons.
And you just got to let the earth do what it's going to do. It's time to thin the herd a little bit.
Is that a natural thing?
Yeah.
Like, everyone gets pissed off when humans do stuff that kind of fucks things up. Pollution, the death rate from cancer goes up because we put power lines up and shit like that. But the naturally occurring things, we go, well, that's nature, and we got to just
deal with it. It truly is. Nature wants to thin the herd a little bit, that's all.
You Birds ain't
so?
Giving me shit.
And is the bird flu going to be done with next year?
Yeah, they'll come up with something else. This is the this year thing.
We kind of did this this bit already, but seriously.
Yeah, we did. We talked
like,
about
hasn't
this
bird flu thing been a danger for many, many years? Why now is it a hot topic?
I have no idea.
Think about all the crazy diseases we heard about growing up. What happened to those diseases?
Rubella?
No, that stuff like the one you get through the Legionnaire's disease.
Legionnaires.
What happened to the Legionnaire's disease?
They found
no war. It was no war they needed to hide.
The French farm Legionnaires.
Yeah, you need a nice war that everybody's trying to figure out how to like take the heat off of this war.
And that's where the bird flu comes from, so we can panic about
that. Is that paranoia? But I just think, you know, it's just falling apart for Bush and his
There was a war going on, still the bird flu.
Watch out!
Bird flu.
The sniffles is killing everybody! Watch out now!
Do you think they sit down there in Washington and figure this shit out? Like, all right, we gotta get the attention away from this horrendous war that's not going our way. As far as the administration goes, so then they meet behind closed doors and go, all
like
right,
a,
look,
like a secret meeting.
Yeah,
thing.
Like,
yeah.
All right, there's this bird flu thing that happens in the Vietnam area. You know, it kills people, and there's always that risk that it could jump, you know, and become a pandemic.
I think what they do is just like they go, you know what? Let's just people want to hear about something else other than this war. They don't go. We're going to hide the war. I think they just go, hey, you know, hey, let's talk about something else.
Right. They keep it all casual.
Yeah, like so it's not like, you know, that's how they killed, you know, Kennedy, whatever. Just shoot the motherfucker.
Wasn't like
inside
the dimly lit room somewhere in a basement with them like making up the plan,
rubbing their hands together.
It was like all light out at an IHOP. They're just like, you know, why don't we just get rid of this guy?
A meeting. Secret squirrel? Yes. Cuckoo mouse? Yes.
Never so like the movies.
The tree is blowing in the wind.
You said the tree is blowing in the wind.
The chewing gum is not being chewed correctly. All right, let's go in the back.
Then I shall throw it away. All right.
I mean, I don't think white people do, because it gives white people too much credit. The white people that I think do that stuff, it gives them too much credit that they're mad scientists like that. You know what I mean? But I think that they know it is like, oh, man. Like, okay, if somebody's in school teasing you, like say you're like one of the guys, the coolest guys in school, and you they hear you got fucking gonorrhea or something. Uh-huh. And they go, oh, Anthony got gonorrhea. But you're really tough, and you go, all right, enough, you know. Enough fucking saying I got gonorrhea, I'm gonna fuck somebody up. And people just go, all right, let's move on from Anthony's gonorrhea.
Cool.
You know what I mean? So they just like, all right, fucking enough of this war, enough of this bad press I'm getting. Let's just talk about something.
All right,
what else
on.
Is fucked up?
Well,
you know,
bird
only 2,000 people, only 2,000 soldiers died. Let's talk about something else. This bird flu potentially could be a pandemic.
Well, we better start covering the bird flu.
But they're not talking about how Saddam, his trial, everyone's dying.
Oh, my God, they're trying to blow up the entire building.
No one is saying, it's like, can I get some news? And I want it from the regular news. I don't want to type up www.thetruthnews.com. I don't want to go find
dot UK
some fucking guy.
Dot .co. Like, you got to go to the goddamn England pages.
You're never going to find real news, ever. There's always going to be a slant no matter what.
Right. It's like...
No matter if you get it on the internet, on your TV, on your cell phone.
Yeah.
GeorgeBushAin'tShit.org. All right, man. I want to hear from Fox.
I think they might be biased.
Can I hear from Fox?
Yeah. No, you're not going to get it. Hey, we got an expert on TV, Eric from Colorado. He's got something on the bird flu. Eric, go ahead.
Hey, morning, boys.
Morning.
Hey,
one of the local talk radio hosts, he's had, like, out here in Colorado, he's had, like, 3 or 4 guests on about this. The bird flu has been a problem. They've been able to trace it back into the 50s, and there's actually been outbreaks of it before. There was one in the late 80s. There was one in the 90s, and worldwide, it has killed less than 500 people in all of the outbreaks that has ever happened from it.
That's nothing.
And
there you go.
Yeah, they said that their biggest concern is the first outbreak was in Europe, and then they never had a problem in Europe until recently. And that's, they said, in the past it always happened in Southeast Asia. They said the only concern that they have is that it has now spread to Turkey and to some other parts of Europe. But otherwise, it's extremely little risk.
That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah, you know, the
next year they won't even be talking about the bird flu, and you got to think to yourself, well, what happened
to that?
What happened to the bird flu? Did they kill all the chickens?
Where are they now for diseases? behind the music for bird
flu. It'll be the I Love the Thousands. The fucking Patrice on there.
Man, what happened to the bird flu?
Bird flu.
What happened to the bird flu? Commenting about the bird flu. I love diseases. What the fuck happened to the bubonic plague? That shit was crazy.
I love each one will have you dressed up with a parrot on your shoulder.
What happened to the parrot? Let me ask my parrot. What happened to the motherfucking parrot?
I love when they state the obvious on those stupid shows. So there was this disease called the bird flu. And what they say is, all right, shut up.
And then they cut to all of them and go, bird flu.
How come I can't get, like, see that guy right there? I can't. Yeah. He's like I hate GeorgeBush.org kind of guy. It's why can't a guy with that information, there be a credible news thing that just says what he just said?
Right, it's just
and
some
I
guy.
Can accept it because it's regular news.
No, but you can go to some other guy or some other news thing and it's the worst disease ever.
Yeah, I mean, I just want to hear, you know, the opposite of the bullshit that we know is bullshit.
I kind of like, you know, and I've always said this when it was just one guy on the news. You turn it on Walter Cronkite. He did all the research for you, blurted out the news that night. It was a wooden desk, a clock behind him.
Stop. A name you
and
can
him.
Trust.
Stop. That was him.
He had his own slant,
Walter
too.
Cronkite. The Tet Offensive proves what the Vietnamese can still mount the defensive. Something the government said that was impossible. I now believe this is a stalemate and declare the war unwinnable.
Then everyone went, holy shit, Cronkite said the war is unwinnable. Well, fuck it.
If the Vietnam War, right, like the back in the day, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
How did that? Now I know the government wasn't going. They weren't somewhere. And that was back when they were really doing bad stuff.
Oh, and they were in charge back then.
They were in charge.
People spoke up. Fuck you.
How come they couldn't hide how bad the Vietnam War was in our eyes? You know what I'm saying? Like, why couldn't they, like, it was like...
Well, it was the first war that they televised on TV.
Yeah, I think
why.
In a limited capacity. It was not like today, where you could punch up the internet and get music videos made by soldiers
but it was,
with video that was taken yesterday.
But it wasn't that limited, because there were so many less channels, so if you did show any type of footage from Vietnam, a lot of people were checking that out.
And it was shit from, like, you know, the soonest they got that stuff to you was like a week later.
Who gave the information out that they was killing villages, like doing the whole crocodile?
Yeah, there were a lot of reporters over there that would, and they weren't reporters like now where they tell you, shut the fuck up and report this.
They were like,
you know, pool reporters.
There was a time where
now.
The news was like actually credible. You know?
Yeah, that shit was like in your face. They would link up with people and walk around and film what they wanted.
Yeah, because they had to go out on their own.
Yeah, these now guys are out there getting shot. Yeah. You've got some Mike Wallace video of that motherfucker being shot at. Some fucking gook is shooting at Mike Wallace, and he's got a microphone. We're here. It's looking really bad.
I think your reporting is going to be a lot more accurate if you go out in the field on your own. With this new war, they're embedding reporters and
stuff.
They're
the
protecting
troops.
Them, so of course you're going to have a slight slant. Like, oh, well, I guess it's not too bad considering they're protecting me pretty well out here.
Yeah, those guys were being shot at.
Going back slightly, Wade in Toronto, Legionnaire's disease. We brought that up a few minutes ago.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Wade.
Hey, guys. How are you?
Hey, man.
Got Legionnaire's disease hit here this past summer. Knocked out 16 people in an old age home.
There you go. 16 people died of Legionnaire's disease.
What's the symptoms of that thing?
It's like some kind of respiratory thing, right?
It's like pneumonia.
You're breathing some bad air.
A lot of people get it from the air conditioning systems.
That's exactly what happened. Two people next door to the old age home came down with the pneumonia, and now they're suing because they said it came through the air conditioning
unit. You got, like, bacteria builds up in the ductwork and blows it out all over the hospital.
Yeah.
Great.
Oh, this was one of the big diseases when we were growing up. That was supposed to kill a lot of people. Yeah. Didn't do shit. Ebola virus didn't do shit. We were all supposed to melt away, remember?
Ebola. Yeah,
that was it for me.
Yeah.
I told you. We were talking about that.
We were talking about that, Ebola.
That was it.
But it's such a motherfucking disease that it can't leave where it starts.
But they haven't cured that.
Who cares?
But all the
who cares about curing
that? There's a million pieces on TV about the Ebola virus. We were all going to get liquefied.
Yeah, I remember that.
Orifices and it was
bleeding from the eyes, nose, mouth, ears, ass, dick, everywhere. You're bleeding from, and then you just like your liquids, your innards turn to liquid, and you just
and
die right
gone.
There.
I don't even know, like somebody like what's the one the baseball player? Lou Gehrig's is bad too. Like, but I never. Like, what?
Who gets that
who
one?
Who gets that? Like, who even...
The Lou Gehrig's.
Like, where does these... which one should we be afraid? You know, I'm really not afraid of anything except for AIDS. Ebola left...
Well, you got to look at what your risk factor is to AIDS.
But I don't believe...
Third world
first
countries.
First of all, who the fuck... Here's the thing that gets me about, like, AIDS. This is what scares me about it. Okay. You know, you got your girl. Yeah, I got my girl now. I'm trying to be sort. You know, I'm doing my thing. I'm doing
the
best I can. So, how do they know? What test do they do that goes, okay, condoms protect you from AIDS, right? Mm-hmm. And you go, okay. What test do they do that lets you know? Do they go, listen, we got $100. We need you to put this on and fuck this girl right here. She got AIDS. I need you to sleep with her just to find out if this shit works.
It's a few college kids that need beer money. That's all.
Yeah, doing the testing.
We've done this bit on the show, man. That you got to see what some of these college kids are doing just to make a few extra bucks.
To make money.
It's
scientific experimentation that's going on with people. They're giving them all kinds of anti-psycho drugs that drive them nuts for a while.
Yeah.
They put
just
implants
for beer money.
In them. They do all kinds of stuff. And they go, what'd you make? I made like $85 for a weekend.
Yeah.
I had to take some anti-psychotic drugs. I barely remember what happened.
I just want to live forever, man.
Yeah.
I really do. I'm one of these guys that just don't want to die, man. I want to just live.
I don't think that shit's going to happen.
I know you just, it's not even, you can't even joke around, but I just want to live long enough to where they invent the machine from the fly. the thing he was trying to build.
Where you can, like, zap yourself
just
over
zap
somewhere.
Just zap myself somewhere, man. Just,
that would be handy.
I would just love to be alive for that. You know what I'm saying?
There you go.
When you're like, I remember when I was, like, 7 or 8 or something, when you first come to the realization that, you know, you're not just going to be skipping through life for eternity.
Seven or eight? Jesus.
Yeah, it's like 7 or 8, and you get.
That's about when you hit for me too.
You know, mortality slips in.
At 7, 8 years old,
yeah,
you
seven,
was
eight.
Thinking about.
You start thinking about like, oh, and you start counting the years and go, all right. And then, but I got to the
point.
I'm
gonna be honest. That's a white guy thing. I'm gonna be.
Is it
very honest?
Yeah.
Black people don't think about life until at least 30.
Really?
At least.
We start thinking about mortality at 30.
White people think about mortality at 8.
Where you go from child where you have no concept of it.
Of anything, and then you wake up one day and go, holy shit, one day I'm gonna die?
One day you drop dead, and that's like what happens? And then, after that, no?
Really?
No, absolutely not.
That was one of the worst days of my life. Maybe that's why y'all plan so well. Like you guys have wills and things like that.
You just
start planning at 8.
But I didn't know. I didn't start planning. You have the realization. But what you do is you start counting years, and you go like, you know, it's gonna be like 2000 in the 2000s, 2000 like I don't know whatever it is, and you think by that time these motherfuckers are gonna have like spaceships on different planets. We're gonna have that all figured out. There's gonna be machines where they could put you in a machine, and then you'll be, you know, you, but in a robot body that looks like you. And what did we get? Nothing. We got internet porn. That's the biggest thing. That's out. But that's
porn.
Another thing. We talked about the flying car, the stupid flying car that we never got that we were promised. But that thing, when you finally hit the realization at like 7, you go, there's so much time that they gotta invent something. It's gonna be in our lifetime that they invent the immortality pill or the fucking thing. And then you grow up and you know what? Ripped off.
Right about now, we're realizing it's not going to be our generation.
It ain't ours.
That's some kids growing up,
it ain't yours either.
That's right.
But we are in a good time, though. We're in a good time, which
we
is
hit the information
the
age.
End of the world fear time. No, are you shitting me?
That's
a great time to be in.
This is not end of the world fear time. End of the world fear time was the friggin' 70s and 80s.
I swear to God,
you never knew. When you used to sit there and smoke pot with your friends back then, you'd start looking up at the ceiling and, like, your shoulders would hunch up because you're thinking, those motherfuckers could launch a bomb right now and incinerate us.
Scarier end of the world now because it's nature end of the world now. Now it's the God end of the world. Diseases, hurricanes, earthquakes.
No, that's just
still a hurricane in the middle of winter. In December,
but
there's an earthquake coming.
Shit that's been around forever and life goes on. The bubonic plague, shit like that, where Europe was, like, decimated. Shit like that stuff has happened before. For some reason, humanity always pulls through. There was always
I'm laughing at old ass Anthony. I know this motherfucker was one of those kids that hit. They did the nuclear
duck
bomb
cover
under the duck table.
Oh yeah, they put our asses under a fucking desk.
And it was a guy with the scratchy thing going, and it was skipping, and you get under the tables.
Here's what we'd be. That's what we'd hear. We go. Uh oh. Air raid alert! Air raid alert! And then
Anthony used to do nuclear bomb.
Students, please get under your desks. Under your desks.
And I'm like, oh, this could be the one. The Russians have launched.
Day after tomorrow.
Yeah.
That was the one. And oh my God.
That's what I grew up in. And when I was in really like elementary school up until about the fifth grade or so, it was get under the desk. Then they changed this fucking thing where from sixth grade, and then they stopped doing it after that, I guess, but we'd have to go out into the hallway. They changed it because I guess we got too big for the desk. Go into the hallway, and then there were the younger students that were against the wall, and our job was to kind of shield them with our body over the eye. And I'm looking at this little kid going,
this motherfucker, I'm a fucking nuclear shield now.
Against the picture, both of y'all fading into dust.
Oh, forget it.
The backwards fade.
Our, yeah.
The fade, you know, fade backwards into the nuclear dust.
With our shadows burnt on the tile wall of the elementary school.
Looking like Pompeii and shaking both
hands. False security for everybody.
But I looked, and even then I thought, what if they are using, I am friggin' cannon fodder. They are using me as a meat shield.
Oh, that's funny.
For this kid.
Let's go to the phones. Glenn in New Jersey. Glenn, what's up?
What's up, boys? How you doing?
Hey, real good. Make it fast.
Hey, Patrice, I just want to let you know the reason why the white man has the will is because we don't piss away all of our money on fucking gold rims and diamonds.
Someone's got to get left the gold rims.
I can't be angry at that because it's just, I don't know what it is. We just, white people think about the future more than we do early. The white people think about the future at 15. I'm thinking about the future now because I'm just getting older. I'm thinking about credit now. Like, when I was
now.
In college, I'm like, I owe $5,000. Kiss my nigga. You think you're going to get this $5,000? Mr. O'Neill, you owe $5,000. We're going to go and get your,
whatever.
Take it if you can take it, motherfucker. I got. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but that's a white thing, too, man.
I got four different Social Security numbers.
Oh. Oh, really?
It's like, find it, motherfucker. So, but now I'm like, when I go and I start learning about things like closing costs and mortgage rates and, you know, like.
We can refinance that for you.
Like, percentage, like, what is the,
Interest rates.
You think that's a word that I use from the age of 12 to 32?
No.
Interest rate? I'm like, oh, I can get a car? Yeah, but it's going to be like at least 22% interest.
I
just got a car.
I got the car. You know something? That isn't a black white thing.
Certainly not.
That's a broke, not broke thing. Because when I was broke, I swear to you, same fucking thing. I could care less. I got credit cards with the interest was like 25%. 25% interest, and I'm out there buying VCRs and
like he's Donald Trump
jet skis
Trump.
And then the thought never crossed my mind how I was going to pay for it because it wasn't money.
It was
I
fake
hand
money.
On the plastic.
Yeah.
They give me what I want. You worry about it later.
So you think it's a money thing?
It's
poor,
not poor.
Without a doubt.
White people just and this is not a credit to white people. It's just white people just. Think about different things, I think, as a whole. Not saying better or worse, but I just, like, I think I've spent $120,000 on jewelry.
Yeah.
And I've taken it back. And they never give you what you know, I just get tired of it. And I go, hey, like, got my first couple of dollars, I had a pinky ring that covered my entire pinky. You know what I mean? It went up to my fingernail. So I'm walking around like, what's happening, babe? I'm on the train. You know what I'm saying? I'm on the train and I'm buying gold microphones. And I'm glad I wasn't one of these stupid-ass comics like dumb Nick DiPaolo or stupid Kevin who puts like that, I'm dead serious about this game, happy, smiley, sad face.
The drama.
The drama thing or a fucking microphone to say, hey, I'm in the game, sucker.
Right, tattoo.
But I brought a damn microphone. I bought a giant microphone with diamonds in it and everything. And I just, if I could go back, I wouldn't have.
How much did that cost you?
A microphone.
A microphone like that, a diamond microphone, it came to about $5,000.
Jesus. It came to about $5,000. We all have our vices, though.
Yeah, it's not that's not a vice.
That is a vice.
That's just not a goddamn
You're
vice.
You're buying shit to what? What is it for?
I think it's loneliness. I buy a lot of things out of loneliness. Like,
aww.
Right. And then my girl goes,
there's a lot of lonely black people out there.
I'm here now. You don't need to. Bitch, you ain't filling that void, ho.
I got to buy something.
Porno and, a flat screen. Stupid Bob just bought like a 42-inch flat screen
for
no reason. You know what I mean? For no reason at all. You know what I'm saying? And it's just like, it's that loneliness thing. And that's why I get to have a flat screen TV in a bedroom that's smaller than this. I have a roommate at 36 years old.
Oh,
man.
My God.
I do. I have a fucking roommate.
You were just on HBO, though, bro.
Motherfucker.
And I heard you took the train in today. What's wrong with you?
I see you in fucking movies. I see you.
That's the business, nigga. It's like.
We need an
I'm on on the train. Wait a minute. I'm on the train. Here's how fucking unknown I am. I can't figure it out, man. A dude recognizes me, right? He goes, this is early in the morning. Still coffee time. Everybody's rubbing their eyes. He goes, hey, yeah. Patrice. Hey, man. How you doing, Patrice? I go, hey. Hey, man, I love your comedy. It's great. And I go, cool. I said, wait a minute. Why didn't this motherfucker ask me why I'm on the train? I ain't shit. He goes, hey, man, how you feel? Hey, you should be on the train, stupid.
Yeah, because if Chris Rock was on the train, this guy recognized him. He goes,
Chris Rock, why are you on the train?
That's exactly what he goes.
It would have been everybody's coffee. It wouldn't even needed coffee. No eye rubbing. Chris Rock is on the train.
That's how you bring that around.
They expect you to be on the fucking train.
Hey, man, funny stuff.
Hey, man.
Oh.
Can you, funny stuff. Can you move over a little?
Funny
I need
stuff.
A seat.
I'm walking up the stairs ahead of you, stupid. What? I mean, let somebody else know I shouldn't be on the train.
There's no figuring that shit out.
I was on the train sitting there wanting to tell people, hey, man, my car's all fucked up.
Yeah, I'm never on the train.
I'm get on the train.
Nah.
You're wondering why I got diamond pinky rings. That's because I don't work in the morning.
I'm not on the train.
I'm headed to a radio show. I'm doing show business. Right now. Yeah. No, I don't get it. Like you say, oh yeah, Patrice, you was on HBO and
yeah.
I've had a steady kind of upward career.
Uh-huh.
I can't figure it out. I cannot figure it out. And then here's the thing that gets me. People think I'm funny. That's what bothers me about my career. Oh, Patrice, you're just man, you're a great comic. Thank you. Can I have some fucking money, somebody? Oh, we love Patrice, man. We love him. Oh, I thank you for loving me, but I just, goddamn.
Lifestyle here, could you?
Yeah, you know, could Dane you pump is, Dane Cook is selling out the Continental Airline Arena. I can't. I was on this show. I think you guys. I came on. You had me on like 3 days for it. You know, who showed up at my show the Opie and Anthony people.
Yeah.
Nobody else. Nobody came. Just the O&A people.
Our listeners are as loyal as they come.
They came to the show, but I was like, hey, this is gonna be great. My regular fans. And ONA fans team up together. No, it was just ONA fans and a couple of motherfuckers that scraggled. And and thank God for white people, because they go to comedy shows that they don't know who's performing.
Yeah, yeah.
They just show up. In. And they go, what a surprise, we saw a young man on Broadway. And it's like, but don't I have fans out this motherfucker? Hey, man, you funny as hell. How come you didn't ask me why I'm on a train?
That would have made your day.
Just this guy. Man, what you doing on a train this morning?
Well, my car.
Chris Rock would have woken
up. The driver didn't show up this morning. And why? Well, I'm going to let him go. I've been thinking of letting that man go.
Or have the conductor go, oh, my God. Patrice O'Neill's on the train. Listen, Patrice, you can't ride in the back with the regular people.
Ladies and gentlemen, big treat today. Big treat if you're coming into work a little early on this snowy day. Patrice O'Neill is in the third car back. If you want to take a look, say hi, get an autograph, and ask him why the fuck he's on the train, three cars back.
With my head down, like giving a hey, man, I don't want to be bothered.
Yeah.
I'm sitting with my head straight up. I took my hat off. I'm like, no, people don't recognize me without a hat. Let me put it back on.
You got to get your most recognizable wear on.
I really am not known. God damn it.
Oh, shit.
Very good. Why don't we take our first break? We got Patrice O'Neill in studio today.
Good morning, everybody.
Yes. We got a lot to do. They did a bear hunt in Jersey. We want to talk about that a little bit today. And it's snowing in New York, and the local weather geeks are just going nuts with it.
Well, it's another case where they made a big deal out of it.
Yeah.
Big deal, yesterday, the day before. You go back 3 days, they were talking about this like it was going to be a huge storm.
Right.
And then as we got closer, they're like, well, the National Weather Service is predicting 5 to 8 inches, but our AccuWeather is saying it's not going to be as bad. And right then I knew this is a non-event.
Exactly.
So they got to send their reporters way out to... like Montauk Point.
Well, they got
to
find the one place where it is bad.
Yeah, where it's snowing.
Where it's snowing pretty bad. So we got the reporters just looking stupid.
Yeah.
And we'll get into that audio in just a bit. They're checking out the Opie and Anthony program. Patrice O'Neill in studio today, filling in for Jim Norton, who's out in Hollywood becoming a star.
Big star for
good
HBO.
Morning,
Louis C.K.
Good morning, gentlemen.
This is a show.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Patrice has a lot of fans in Washington, by the way. We were just down there. again.
Oh, really? Cool.
A lot of fans at the XM compound in D.C.
That still doesn't translate to money ever. I got a lot of fans. A
lot of fans. They love you down there at XM.
We should bring you down there for the next trip because, wow.
Please don't. Just don't.
Wow. Maybe you, know maybe you could teach us a thing or two.
I'll piss somebody off down
yeah.
there.
No, dude, we don't give a crap about that. We just want to make sure we get from the hotel to the compound safely. And I think you could be a very good ambassador to get us to the compound.
I think the very formidable Poe would be a great visit with you to protect you from any, as he karate kicks everybody. Like, Eric Logan left me a nice message or something. I didn't know. I called him. I didn't know how to leave. I don't know how to leave. Like, I was like, hey, hey, I wasn't even sure how to really talk. You know what I mean? It's like, what am I going to say to this guy? He runs a station or runs a goddamn company. And I'm just like, hey, man, thanks a lot. Yeah. And I'm like, after I hung up, I go, whew.
Should I have been like...
Was that enough for like a fucking CEO or something?
Sir, in response to your voicemail of the 12th of November, I would like to respond in kind with a...
And well, thank with I, quotes and you with you, quotes and you know sincerely what? With well, quotes.
When Logan calls me, I just don't call back. Because I have, I don't know. I'll get it filtered through Opie.
I'm like, thanks a lot, man. Can't. Like, if you, no, want, I,
I'm
and
the
you
same
appreciate
way.
It, it's just like, hey, thanks.
Because we're on to him. Yeah, you're not on to him yet. Mm-hmm. He's just like us. He just has a better haircut, that's all.
Suit.
Amy in Georgia. Amy, what's up today?
Nothing. How are you guys doing?
Pretty good, man.
I just wanted to play What's in My Pants. Can I do that today?
Oh, we have not played.
Have we ever played Guess What's in My Pants with Patrice O'Neal?
No.
Ah, then we got to play.
Of course we do.
I thought you were calling for tissue time, but we'll do that a little later.
Yeah, no, I don't have time for that, but I wanted to play What's in My Pants.
Where are you?
In Georgia.
Yeah, where in Georgia? Like home?
No, I'm in my car right now.
All right, I got to figure all this out. Give me a pad and a piece of paper.
In your car?
And a pen, I mean.
Are you driving?
No, I'm waiting to be able to go.
All right, how old are you?
27.
So far,
okay.
So good.
He's riding. All right. Height?
I'm 5'2".
5'2".
Oh, boy. Okay.
She's a petite gal.
Oh, boy.
That's good.
No, that's good so far.
All right. Breast size?
I'm actually a 34B.
34B. That's okay. What's the problem so far, Opie?
34B. That's about as big as a tit should be. Right.
Yeah. 34B, do you know your... And now here comes the big question. And we know already the plus factor. So put plus 5.
Plus 5. Okay, go ahead.
How much do you weigh?
It's about 120, so 125.
125.
Yeah, 5'2", 125.
5'2", with B's.
I think that's the same size as Michael Westbrook from Philadelphia. Is it?
Do you have,
she's a squatty little thing.
Do you have a butt on you?
Yeah, that's what it is.
Yeah, that's where. I was wondering where the extra couple of pounds came from.
White girl?
Yeah. Are you a gymnast?
No. No, but I do have a lot
the
of
Mary
muscle.
Lou Retton.
That's where it comes from.
You got a lot of muscle.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
A little muscle.
All right. Well, this actually isn't just to see what you look like for some kind of fantasy thing. It does help out in guessing the hairstyle.
Sure.
Okay.
Certain girls of certain heights and weights have certain hairstyles on the average. But you never know. She could surprise us. You want to play the song?
Well, you want to do the rules first or...
I think we do the song first.
All right, let's do the song first.
Stupid song first.
He's got to play. He's got to play. He's got to play. Hey, guess what's in my pants?
Happy song, Mr. Early.
Place the receiver up on your beaver. It's time to play. Hey, guess what's in my pants? It's time to guess what's in my pants. My pants.
All right, Amy. Here are the rules for the people at home. Amy, at no time are you to tell us what you have in your pants or give us a hint until we ask you.
Okay.
And for the people playing at home, you could play at home. It's great. She's going to take the phone, rub it as per our direction on her most intimate of area, and we will ask her to rub it back and forth, up and down, and in a circular fashion. And based solely on the sound coming from the phone, we will discern
the hairstyle.
Absolutely.
That is in her pants.
We're experts at this, Patrice.
Here are the choices. The basic standard issue woman triangle of hair.
Okay.
This could be a big 70s Earth Mama muff or a trimmed type of kept clean
full,
triangle. But we're talking
triangle.
Full triangle. Now, you can say it's a big bush or it's a nicely trimmed triangle. That'll get you extra points. That's amazing if
but
you can do that.
But there's no hair. The length of hair is what counts, but
right.
Not the... There's no lining. There's no...
Right. They've left the natural shape, just kind of trimmed down the height of it a
okay.
little bit.
Okay, okay.
Then there is the mohawk. Everybody that's been to a strip club knows what this is. It's the strip of hair that goes down. It's usually...
Clip.
Yeah. It's okay. usually as long as the triangle was high.
Right.
They don't shave down the top of it at all. It's just a strip.
It looks good until they stand up.
You
well,
don't see that
no,
you don't see that much anymore, though.
That doesn't look bad standing up. What looks awful standing up is, or laying down on their back, is the Hitler mustache. This is the mohawk, but they have not only trimmed in the sides, they have cut down like from the belly button downward
okay.
till it is a little Hitler mustache. It's a tuft of hair.
Okay.
That's like what Ray Charles had right there under his lip.
It's a goatee.
It looks ridiculous when their legs are spread because it's like shaved, but then there's this patch of hair out of nowhere.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. Looks silly. Then, of course, all the rage lately, the wood floor. Clean shaved, nothing there, or, as we like to call it on this program, the JonBenet Ramsey.
Oh.
Just nothing.
Why did you raise your eyebrows?
About what?
You don't
no,
like
not
the,
that part. Before that.
You don't like the clean shave?
You're not seeing the clean shaven out there a lot?
Well, not with Brazilian girls coming in.
No, black girls don't really do that either.
No.
Black girls don't shave at all?
Not, it itches when it grows back, and
yeah.
and they get...
Wow,
the same,
we're learning something
the stuff,
today.
The same stuff that black men will get on their face.
Get the razor bumps down
yeah,
there?
Yeah, razor bumps
oh.
and stuff. They're not very careful.
You
so
don't want
it,
that.
The itching and the... And the, so a lot of times black girls... black women have one that you miss that I don't know white girls do.
Mm-hmm.
It's the triangle... It's the triangle Hitler mustache. It's the triangle, but instead of the whole vagina, it's the from the clit up. So they trim it so it is
oh,
a,
I got
triangle
it.
Oh, yeah, okay.
from the clitoris up
wow,
to
wow, yeah,
you know,
yeah.
And the middle's taken
I've
out,
seen
right?
that.
The, all the extra from the side and the... And
yeah,
the,
and the lips
out.
And everything is all...
All
everything's
that shave,
clean.
But the, that's, that part is a triangle,
right.
yeah.
Okay. That's
so.
Interesting.
All right, Amy, you're naked?
Amy, yeah, where are you're in your car. What
I'm
are you wearing?
I'm in my car, so I just had to... I'm getting ready for work, so...
What are you wearing, pants, skirt?
Yeah, pants.
Pants, and so got them pulled down?
Just a little bit.
You could
but
access... you got to be able to access that bush or whatever it is you got down there, okay?
No, we're good.
All right, if you can take the phone now and rub it up and down on your area, we will listen in.
Okay, hold on.
All right. Mm-hmm.
Is that good or not?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
that's good.
Good. That's good. That's telling. It's a little telling. Okay, now side to side.
Okay, hold on.
Hmm. I need more side to side
there.
Yeah,
definitely.
Yeah, do it like, I don't know, about 5-6 times.
Okay, hold on.
I heard something there.
Yeah, yeah. But I don't think it was hair-related.
No,
all right, Amy? Can I ask you another question?
Sure.
Are you married?
No.
Have you ever had any children?
No.
Oh, okay, just asking. Now the circular fashion, if you just take it and go in circles around the area.
Okay, hold on.
All right.
I need the side to side again.
Side to side?
Yeah.
All right, like 5 times, side to side, please.
Okay, hold on.
It's a tough one.
It's not too tough.
It's
oh,
tough.
Wow.
Okay. I'm hearing something.
But I don't think it's hair that I'm hearing.
I thought I heard the anatomy. Phone. I thought I heard the phone getting stuck on the skin and then pop.
Yeah, that's what I think.
So
I'm hearing.
I was gonna go with completely shaven, but now I think I got to change my thing.
I think it's sounding a little too. You would think. See, here's a misconception. I'll help some of the people out. That the clean shaven is very quiet,
mm-hmm.
like this. Clean shaven is loud. When they shave it, you hear. This sounds like some hair is padding it, but I can't quite figure out how much.
All right, I'll start.
I hope he's going to start. What are you going with?
I'm
going
to take a big chance here. I think it's a it's a triangle.
All right, you're going to say the natural triangle, but trimmed a little bit?
Yeah, exactly.
All right. Now, any triangle will get you the win. Mm-hmm. That'll just be an amazing credit to you and your ears.
Thank you.
If it is trimmed.
Thank you.
Patrice?
Same thing.
Something
going on there.
Matter of fact, no husband, no kids, little goofy, little squatty girl. I say full bush.
Right. Wow.
We've never found a full bush.
There's no reason for this little mess to shave.
Wait, there's a couple other questions we should ask. Are you married or you're not married, you don't have a boyfriend?
No, I don't have a boyfriend.
I mean, she's going out a lot.
Is she a lesbian?
So she's going to keep it all nice down there.
Lesbian?
No, not lesbian.
Okay.
All right,
I heard, here's what I'm going to say. I'm going with the mohawk because I heard something on that side to side that I can't get it out of my mind. I think it was, now with a full bush, I don't think you'd have heard that deviation in the middle of the stroke there.
Nah, she's trying to, just like her phone rub is the same thing as her life where she's trying to convince you of things.
Yeah.
This is a lonely little mess. And she has a full bush, and she knows this game, so she knows the skills.
Anthony, you weren't paying attention. She's,
why?
She said she's a little big down there.
Yeah.
She's calling it muscle.
But it's heat.
What you were hearing there is like a vag dimple.
No. Oh, Jesus. You think it's a little bit of plumpness?
Yeah, a little stussy.
I'm thinking that she would trim it up, though, because that's one thing she can do to make it a little nicer down there.
This little poor thing is struggling a little bit. I feel she doesn't pay that much attention. She's rushing to work.
I like
There's
this one,
no
though.
Way it's trimmed up.
Because, Amy, I got to tell you, a lot of the Guess What's in My Pants contestants that have called up, we've right off the bat just gone boom, boom, boom. This is it. This is it. A lot of us have the same guess. You've kept us kind of in a mystery over here. Well, I guess it's time. Amy, if you would tell us what is in your pants.
Opie was right.
It's a trimmed triangle.
A trimmed triangle.
Both of Opie gets it. Trimmed triangle. Beautiful. Great job. And Patrice gets credit, though, too, for the triangle.
I wanted to just be right with you, Obi, but I just... Damn it!
I really thought I heard the skin getting caught.
Was it the skin?
But then when she did it the second time, then it was a smooth stroke all
Amy,
the way
Amy, do you know what's that deviation that you got going down there?
I'm not sure what you mean.
It made a sound. It went like... like it was falling into something in the middle of your stroke.
Oh.
Is it a little plump? Do you have a plump one down there?
Not particularly.
No? Is there a definite, like, cleft in the middle?
No, but you're getting me a little worried here.
No, don't be worried.
We're just...
It's a pussy. Guys love them.
That's right.
Doesn't matter what the fuck. Don't you worry.
Yeah, that's why I thought it was a bush.
Yeah.
Just because of her whole demeanor. Just little poor thing.
Well, bravo, Opie.
She takes abuse well.
Thank you, Anthony.
Good girl.
Yeah.
I don't do well in this game usually. But,
I'm thinking about it too much.
I'm starting to pay more attention on this show, I heard some things. Amy, thank you so much.
Thanks, guys.
Dimple.
And thanks for playing Guess What's in My Pants.
Bum, bum, bum. He's got to play. He's got to play. He's got to play. Hey, guess what's in my pants? Place the receiver up on your beaver. It's time to play. Hey, guess what's in my pants? It's time to guess what's in my pants. My pants. All right, there you have it. That came out of nowhere today.
I see Dimple.
I thought we were going to do tissue time. No, maybe later.
A little later we'll do
a new bit.
Another installment of Tissue Time.
You have a housekeeper that comes over, a Polish housekeeper opening? Does she still come over for your house?
She'll be there tomorrow. It's my my luxury, yes.
See, this is a Manhattan thing that is, I think, great. Anybody can get this type of housekeeper.
Mm-hmm.
I'm in a very nice neighborhood, and it's very hard for me to find. I just want somebody that can come in and, a little dusting, a little cleaning of the bathroom and things like that, and can't find one. So yesterday, it's like you're holding auditions. This crew comes in to do the initial cleanup. Because it's been a while, and I'm looking for another house, so it's not like I have a lot of furniture or anything in this one.
Right.
It's almost like, the flop house, a base of operations to find the real house. So I didn't buy a bunch of furniture for the living room or anything like that. We got a TV room set up with a couch and TV and my computers and stuff like that, but not a lot of stuff. So it wasn't really important to have a housekeeper come in, but I like one to come in maybe once a week. Once every 2 weeks, something like that. Just dust everything off. So yesterday, this crew comes in. I don't know where they're from. It looked like what I would picture people from Guatemala
different,
to look like.
They're from countries we haven't discovered yet.
What happened?
there's countries out there we haven't discovered
just
yet.
Just some tribe out of the rainforest. They looked like Incas. They had the face of Incas. You know that very distinct look with the guy that wears that derby hat down in South America?
Where they built shoes?
Yeah,
they
built
little squatty boxes.
Squatty thing. I don't know what they were. What happened to, all right, Mr. C, I'll be here again in 2 weeks. I vacuumed the floor. What happened to Americans,
white people
that just come in and clean your
white
house?
White people don't want to do that shit.
I don't know.
What American cleans a house?
Hazel. Hazel.
Hazel ain't cleaning a house.
Hazel in the good old 50s.
The good old 50s where you could sit back, smoke a Lucky, and watch her clean your house.
The good old
Hazel,
50s.
Do you mind watching our kids at war? Honey, there's no more honey child motherfuckers cleaning your house.
I want white people.
There truly was the good old days when it was all about the white people.
Honey?
The maids, the thing that I want. Either that or, I either want Hazel or I want a mammy.
She wipes the dust and goes, now, Mr. Anthony, what is this? What is this? And then wipes the dust on the tip of his nose. Nah, you know that's not necessary.
I want to ask something as she's doing the dishes and have her pick up the big apron to dry her hands. I'll get right on that right away. It's just something. Something classic.
And when there's money around, she leave it there. There was money there now, Mr.
Nah, I didn't touch that money.
I didn't touch that money now, Mr.
Get honest as the day is long. That's what I'm looking for.
She knows where your hidden cameras are to make sure she looks at them and goes, I ain't shaking your child now, Mr. Anthony. Nobody's shaking your child to death.
That's what I'm looking for. Someone I can speak to.
Yeah.
It was a woman, and I think, I don't even know how many people were in my house yesterday. Three guys, I'll say. I think three guys. They came in with some stuff, but I needed all kinds of cleaning stuff. I don't know where this shit is. I don't even know if I have it.
They don't bring their own cleaning
stuff. Bring your own stuff!
They don't.
I'll pay.
I learned that the first time the Polish maid came
over. She comes and she's like, do that paper towel. Do that paper towel. All I heard was paper towel, and I panicked. I'm going, oh, shit. So now I'm running around trying to find, paper towels. I finally found some. Three rolls, to which, a half hour later, more paper towel. I do it in the window.
All about the paper towels.
And I'm like, motherfucker, I had to run out. I had to run out and leave them alone in my house as I ran out and got paper towels.
The person you set the cleaning up with, they were American.
It's like they're American, but then they send over the crew, and the crew is, I don't know, Guatemala. I don't know where they were from. So they're around. So now I'm looking, and I start thinking, because, I got my racist mind working, and I'm going, they could just be scoping out the house. And these cleaning guys now, they could be unlatching windows, leave them unlocked, shit like that. And I did notice my slider in the back.
they didn't lock the big lock, the
You're
good lock on the
Patrice
slide.
O'Neil.
So you know what
Jesus
I did?
Anthony, I'm sorry. Keep that thought, Mr. fucking entitlement.
Here's what I did, though,
oh my
to combat
God.
This, to give them any second thought, to give them second thoughts about breaking into my motherfucker. First of all, they clean under my bed.
This is called an investment.
So they pull out, they just pull out artillery from under my bed, which, you know, let them know I'm armed. And then I sat there at my desk.
Is your artillery really under your bed?
Yeah. Keep it under my bed.
What the fuck's wrong with
it's
you?
Good
man?
Shit. I got, oh, the shit I got. And then I sat at my computer desk as they're cleaning and coming up and asking me questions, watching me, with 30-round AR-15 clips just loading 223s into it as they're watching me. I'm loading 500 rounds of ammo into my AR-15 magazines. Just, oh, yeah, it's over there. Dude, they were lined up. I had 30-round clips. I had my 10 rounds. 500 rounds. I'm just pounding them in. Chick, 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 chick. See, the that's good. And the they have no idea.
The culture of fear has gotten to this man right
it's
here.
It's disgusting, man. You
Why?
You see that movie Crash?
Yeah.
What's the girl, what's the stupid girl there? Sandra Bullock.
Right, Sandra Bullock.
Like, who even thinks that? And you know what? People just because they speak all these, they're smart. So you know they're sitting there like, I think about it. One of them wants to go, meet the Anthony. They're not, we are not going to come back to rob you. You don't need to pretend to load your pistol. Because we're not what we're going to clean and leave. Please.
The key is you got to tip them well, that's all.
Tip them? I paid them.
Mr. Anthony, we don't need this in your window.
You have to
clean the windows.
Up.
No. In your window.
In your window.
I paid them what the estimate was.
Oh, boy.
Oh.
That could be a problem.
Why?
They went away a little angry.
Dude, I paid them above and beyond what should have been paid. She came up with a price, and I'm like,
what a
fucking
cracker you are.
And I am a cracker-ass cracker.
What the I can't believe he's such a... How did you become such a cracker?
I am frightened.
I would think Opie would be... I would just swear you... not knowing the two of you.
No.
I would say...
He's
I
whiter.
Would bet money, just like that coochie game.
Why, just because I look whiter?
Just because you just seem like you would be whiter than Anthony. Anthony just looks like he's done so much...
No, you got it wrong.
I know. I don't have it wrong. I'm saying if I had to prejudge the situation, I can't believe Anthony's this.
Like that has never happened.
Like if Opie talked like this, I'd be like, Opie looks like he probably
really.
Yeah, yeah.
Like a goddamn cleaning crew has never come into a place and kind of, you know, the guy maybe they're reputable and the company's reputable and they hire people, but then the guy goes and tells his friend, "Hey, I was at some
they
house today."
They don't have any friends.
And
they pick those people up on the side of, like, Martin Luther King Boulevard in the morning. They don't have working papers. They'll do anything. They're not trying to rob your house. They're not.
All I want to know...
They can't even reach the windows. They're 4'7".
Can I just get American...
No.
White American people anymore?
What white people clean houses?
Here was my call to the chimney guy. Because I'd like to get a crackling fire in my fireplace in the living room. So I want to make sure the chimney's fine.
You know he's walking around with a pipe at home.
I want to make sure that...
He's got an ascot. He's got an ascot.
It's a Norman Rockwell scene.
A book that he hasn't finished reading for a magnifying glass.
Anthony wants to live the good life.
A fucking bear rug.
I want to live... My house
wants
is
to live
like
the good life.
It's 1955.
Yeah, so he's got... Yeah.
I got
Anthony, what do you want? You want hard-working foreigners, right? Or some old white woman with personality that won't work. Just like old white women waitresses.
I want 1955. I want white people that come in and work.
They don't work anymore because they...
Where did they go?
No, listen, Patrice is right, man. If you want a job done, you got to get the foreigner.
A foreigner, man.
They work their balls off.
Those old white women. You ever have an old white woman waitress? Honey. They sound like the old Hazels, though. They don't work.
The waitresses with the pet names for you?
Because you know why they send foreigners? So you can't, like... charm them. Like, you go coochie-coo to an old white woman, and she goes, okay, I'll give it to you. I'll clean the stove, and I won't tell anybody. They go, no, clean here, clean there. Goodbye, there's no coochie-coo with these foreigners. They don't speak English.
I don't know what happened. Where did they go? Where did the white people go?
Overseas.
Did
jobs.
They leave?
They're still there, but they're,
I want the nice housekeeper that's with the big beehive hairdo.
This is what's going to cause the race war.
And
this right here.
Does that. And then yesterday, I'm trying to clean out my I get my chimney, make sure it's nice and good. So I call up, I go through, I find two brothers chimney cleaning.
Oh, boy.
Sounds two like, black chimney cleaning?
Yeah, that's what I... No, it was... It was two brothers.
Two brothers, not like, two black guys.
I figured it's a couple of white guys, enterprising guys, going into business. And I call up, and it's like,
well, they're not smart businessmen.
Hello, two brothers, chimney clean, what you need?
B-R-U-D-E-R-N.
Fucking Russian guys. Oh. They're Russians. And you know this guy, again, like...
In my country, before the end of Soviet Union, I was engineer at the rocket program. Now I got to clean fucking chimneys.
So he's all bitter and angry, and he won't even come. He goes, weather don't look good. I will call you back when weather clears. It's like the weather with flurries. These are the days I want a crackling fire in my fireplace, where I can open my front windows up and see the snowfall in my neighborhood.
How do you know you need your chimney done, though?
I don't, but I don't want to put a log in there and burn it up if there's a big clog in it. So I want the Russian to go through there and make sure it's... you know, clean. Because this could be carbon monoxide, deadly carbon monoxide.
No carbon monoxide.
How on my house blowing up with smoke?
This guy.
And Anthony, you got barbed wire in your there's barbed wire in the
there is
in the chimney.
Spools of concertina wire around my compound.
Why barbed wire in the chimney? These little inkers came yesterday. It made me nervous.
Did I tell you how I leave the house every morning?
Anthony, do you have a parakeet in your basement to make sure
there's
no
carbon monoxide? Canary in a coal mine.
They take the canary out.
Gas mask on.
Get out of here. The canary's dead.
Here's how I leave my house in the morning.
I have a system. This, Patrice.
I have the door that goes from my house to the garage, which, of course, has a lock on it. So I go through that, and then I lock that door.
It's like, get smart.
Then I get into my truck, and I lock those doors, right? Now I buckle in. Now I open the garage door. The garage door opens, and I pull out. So that way, any bad guys would be stuck, you know, in the middle there if they're trying to get into my house through the garage, and they can't get into my vehicle because the door's locked. So you got to keep an airlock away from you and the criminals. They're out there.
The paranoia is not. It's acceptable. Some of the paranoia. I get that paranoia myself. But you can't. You just can't do that, man.
Did you hear about these people that get pistol whipped and tied up and robbed? It ain't gonna be me, motherfucker. It ain't gonna be me.
The only time I think on that level is it's not from a person robbing me. It's from the police. Like in case I ever get in some shootout. That I always thought about buying two houses right across the street from each other and dig a tunnel and have a rail system.
No, that's brilliant.
I might go in there and I go, hey, come on. Oh, fuck you, cops. And I shoot in and I get on my rail system and slide over to the other
house. Like the Great Escape. You lay down on that skateboard on the rails. Hit with the shovel. Ding, ding.
That's
someone
the only
pulls
paranoia
you
I have is police doing something to me. But that whole...
Could you see... You know, let me ask you this. Anybody that's been in a home invasion out there in Suffolk County, Nassau County, my area that I live in, home invasion, when it's happening to them, they are going, holy shit, this is fucking happening to me. What the fuck am I going to... I don't have shit here. I have a box. I'm going to hit them with a box of tissues that are on my night table. That's it. Someone comes into my fucking room, they are going to be shocked.
No, they're not.
Yes, they are.
Under the
it's
going
to look like Fallujah.
It's under the bed.
They got to get into my room first.
You didn't even scare the Incas. They go, this idiot keeps the guns under the bed.
He's not giving all his secrets away.
They
got to still have to get into
his
room.
They got to get into my room.
And I'm sure
that door's locked at night, motherfucker.
Anthony has a button like Quagmire from Family Guys where the bed flips into the mat.
Oh, yeah.
Safe room.
Ant's basically sleeping in a panic room at this point.
That door is locked, so if I hear somebody rustling around in a house...
Your girl stays with you, or she stays at her own place?
She stays with me.
So is she accepting to this paranoia, or she's like, Anthony, come on now.
You should see her rack that shotgun, my friend.
You know these two motherfuckers are like the two from Tremors. They're waiting for a giant worm to attack. Give me the X5 in it, honey. Homemade dynamite. You two fucking psychos.
Anyone that breaks into my fucking house is going to have to contend with some serious shit.
And this is the stuff.
I hope they didn't bring a knife.
What if I just come over and just go surprise? Anthony, happy birthday, surprise!
Surprise! You'll be surprised at the sucking chest wound that you will have.
And this is the stuff that he's willing to admit on the show. He's got other things in place.
He's got other things in place.
He's got tripwire.
No. This is my rent.
A lot of motion detectors.
Let me tell you
something. No one in the neighborhood can sleep because Anthony's lights keep coming on the porch.
Yeah, it looks like a disco out back.
Walking his dog. Hey, Anthony. No, it ain't me. It's my motion detector. Anthony, why do you need a motion detector 60 feet away from your house? Just in case there's motion.
This is just the rental. So I don't have any type of high-tech cameras up.
Things.
Once I move into a house,
forget it.
I want all the latest. I want it like Scarface with the cameras. I want to see the Colombians coming over the wall.
Why not live in... This is why I don't move from cities.
What?
You feel... All that
the
is a different security feeling to the city where you walk in, there's a doorman, you walk, you get on your elevator, there's not a lot of that going on.
Yeah, tell the woman that got raped by the fireman guy. Yeah, sure.
Well, but
tell the cop's family.
That was a goddamn elaborate
scheme,
though.
Tell that cop's family. Guy pulls over, guy for speeding. Ah, he's shot.
Oh,
you know, where does he live?
That has nothing to do with the paranoia
you have. There are nasty, nasty people in
this
city.
There's nasty people in Long Island.
Of course there are, and I am defending myself against them.
But it's the difference between, okay, it's lesser two evils. It's maybe get shot as a cop pulling somebody over, or maybe getting raped by a guy pretending to be a goddamn fireman, which is a pretty elaborate scheme.
That is.
Here.
I'll give you that.
Or home invasions.
I lived in fucking Brooklyn.
Which are home invasions are right. This is what I'm saying. If you live in a place that could get home invaded, you're living in a place where you're going to be killed because home invasion is one of those crimes that's right under murder. Like, four steps under murder, you could go to jail for the rest of your life. So if you're willing to invade a home, you're willing to kill somebody.
That's why he's got the guns.
Kill them first. I want a nice house. Why should I run in fear from a nice suburban house because some people want to invade homes?
How many rooms you got?
Right now, three bedrooms.
Three bedrooms.
Anthony's looking forward to killing somebody.
No. I'll be honest with you. I'll be very candid.
If you kill an Inca?
I will be very candid and honest with everybody out there. I would feel awful, and it would probably change my life and forever, like it would anyone else that had to take somebody's life. But it sure is better than, me laying there with a hole in me.
True.
You got to think on those terms.
All right.
And why am I running in fear from a suburbia? I'd rather just
batten myself in. You shouldn't die. But I'm just saying the paranoia in which you're living right now.
It's not paranoia. I am a realist.
That's not realist.
It is realist because those people that were tied up with their phone cords or this one that gets raped or pistol whipped or shot from a home invasion are every single one of them. You're not just going, oh, God, a home invasion. Well, I should have seen this coming, I guess. You're sitting there going, oh, my God, it's happening to me right now.
That's like
Holy shit.
That's like Final Destination, that movie where death is chasing you.
Stalking him.
Right. You're, like, trying to fight death off. Like,
no, it's not a sure thing.
It's going to happen.
That ain't no sure thing. If they're in my house and I got to look around for a fucking pen... Then, maybe I could jab it in his throat before he shoots me. No. I want weaponry that I could that overpowers theirs, that takes them by surprise. If they happen to bust through my fucking door, I will be behind my thick mattress, and the second I see them, gone. But they won't even get a chance to see, are they sleeping?
But you're in a rental.
Yeah.
If you're, I'm thinking if you're going to do some home invading, you're looking for the really nice houses.
What, are they looking at my lease first?
With the nice...
I have a very nice house.
Well, obviously, but it's just renting.
Well, he's not a homeowner.
Like, look at his interest rates. He's got enough problems.
I don't think your landscaping is up to par.
My landscaping is gorgeous.
So I'm thinking
what do you think, I do that?
Wait, so you
have
a landlord?
I have Mexicans that come over and do... Yeah.
Yeah.
I have a landlord. Yep.
And he's allowing you to put barbed wire and all that. Why?
I don't have barbed wire. My house is a lovely suburban home from the outside.
And does your front door open and close like
House
Texas Chainsaw
inside.
Massacre? Like gong. If somebody's trying to rob Andy, he come out with a hammer, bump him on the head.
Clock him on the head, and then the door just shuts. I drag him in.
Anthony's Leatherface with beautiful eyes.
Blink, blink,
blink, blink. Blink, 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 Leatherface.
If he could, he would build a moat around his house. But the landlord won't allow it.
Oh my God.
Yeah, you got a chainsaw under that bed?
No chainsaw.
Anthony sounds like the Crusades. Anthony's like, who goes there? It's Patrice, Andy. How you feeling?
Identify yourself. Friend or foe?
The bird in July flies highly over the mountaintop. All right.
Call sign.
And then it's like a bank, like a Brazilian bank. You got to walk in to a door. That door closes, and then another door opens.
The airlock of safety I was telling you about. These people know. See?
You're not in a third world country.
Have you been to Brentwood or Wyandanch out on Long Island?
Anthony has third world bank security.
Hey, Steve's got a question for Anthony from D.C.
Yes, Steve.
Hey, did you taught your old lady how to use a shotgun?
What's that?
You taught your old lady how to use a shotgun?
Of course I did.
What about a vacuum cleaner? Can she figure that out?
Steve, what year do you think this is? 1957?
Punch it out, boys.
What do you think? And what do you think?
Women ain't doing the shit work anymore.
What do you think? Our girlfriends are doing housework?
Oh, and that's what
Stop it.
She's pumping a shotgun. First of all, she has to. She's going to get killed if she has to take the shotgun, take both hands, lean the butt of it on her knee.
No.
And she clicks it down, and then it flies up too hard. It flies out of her hand. There's no way she's holding it going.
Yeah, I got to get a little 8 gauge.
Yeah, you need to get her.
Got to get the girl's
a 32
weapon.
Special. Yeah, get her a girl's weapon. She can't be pumping shotgun.
Yeah.
We gotta stop this for now because we got to take a break. We got lots to do today.
Yes, we really do.
What the hell is that?
Why? Hello?
I don't know what that is. Hold on.
Who the what the?
All right. As we go to break, from the eggnog drinking contest, we got one of these puke remixes that came in. This is Joe from Boundbrook, New Jersey. Remember
that? Alrighty, sure.
We loved the eggnog drinking contest this past Friday. All the video clips are now up on opieandanthony.com. What's wrong, Patrice?
This is the Opie and Anthony program on XM Satellite Radio. It's a virus. It's spreading. The good old ONA virus. Getting more gooder every day. Patrice O'Neill killing for us today. Patrice, you promoting anything? You got to come in here with something to promote. You're giving all these people big laughs and you got nothing? Don't expect us to pay you.
Promoting anything?
This is how it works, bro. You get a stupid club somewhere or a theater.
I mean, the next time I'm doing comedy is in January.
That's how you get paid. Don't look at us for a paycheck, bro.
This is what happens.
You come in with something that is already happening out there that you got planned.
Anything in my head. I just get up and get on the train and come down.
But you
and
can't
hang
be
out.
Giving these people these big laughs and have nothing.
What do you want?
You got to have a MySpace account. You got to have a website. You got to have something.
People. You know, I got to figure out how to do these things. I'm oblivious.
How about
to
you just panhandle something? Give us a street corner where you're going
to
be panhandling. That's how you get paid to do our show.
I'm oblivious to this shit, man.
Dane got where he is, but with this big grassroots movement he had online.
That's right.
Selling his own shit.
Grassroots movement.
MySpace, he got on that.
Cheek. I don't... Who the fuck knows
about being
successful? I you got to learn these things, I suppose. But I'm not a pet. I can't peddle my stuff.
2005, almost 2006. You should have a website by now.
Talking about a covered wagon selling elixirs.
I just got Comcast. I just got cable modem. I used to.
What?
You would dial up?
I'm telling you.
You're one of the last dial up guys?
I'm not proud to be a complete idiot, but I'm saying is I don't like after the show when I see Voss and them, after people pay $20 to muscle them for another $20 for shit that you just said for a CD. You know what I mean? It's like I hate doing that to people. Like I want my
but
I
they
want
don't
my,
have to buy it. Some people want this stuff.
If they want, I'm gonna learn how to give it to them when they for people
see,
who are
that's
not
why
manhandling
you need
them
to get
saying,
online.
You know, buy my
so
shit.
So you could sell it to people that haven't heard your act,
that's
but they
right.
hear you here on the show maybe,
that's
and go,
right.
"This guy sounds funny. I'd like to see what he does."
I need a marketing plan,
dude.
Yeah.
If you had a CD, we could sell you a lot.
I'll get a CD.
We could sell a lot of them.
And then I hate to impose that kind of shit. They're like, "Hey, oh, you think you can?" I just like to come and make people laugh. But it's not working in terms of pocket change.
No.
In terms of money, dude. Just having an ethic ain't working, motherfucker. I got to get me a MySpace account.
If you had a comedy show in New York, you're going to do the show the rest of the week, we'd sell out the place for you. No problem. Ask Bill Burr. I got an email from Bill recently. He said,
oh, you did.
He was at, I think, Rascals Thanksgiving weekend. He said the O&A fans came out in droves, and it was one of the best weekends he's ever had in comedy.
Yeah, tell Bill.
And that's just because he was doing the radio show. Our fans are very loyal. They support.
I'm not arguing.
But,
it's just,
but
what are
they don't
you
know,
do?
They don't know how to support
you. You don't know.
If you see Patrice, give him a dollar, I guess.
Yeah,
I mean, Jesus.
If you see me on the train, say, man, why are you on the train? You got to understand.
Fuck, dude.
You gotta understand how hard it is to be to. I was trying to have an ethic. That ethic thing. It works in terms of having. You like you guys. You don't. You have the show.
Yeah.
So it's like when you do certain things, you can promote it, but you don't. Like I've been doing comedy 13 goddamn years. I wanna like kind of move to that level, but it's just look. It's goddamn difficult for me. I don't know. I don't have a MySpace account. I don't answer
dude.
Every email that somebody sends me.
Patrice.
Hey, I loved you. When you gonna be in
Patrice,
Chicago next week?
Hire a Jew.
I have
to do all the dirty work
army
for you.
Jews around.
Hire a Jew.
The dumbest Jews working for me.
You'll
ever.
Be playing theaters all over the East Coast. You'll get a CD out, a website.
My Jews are not good
because
Jews.
Because they know, you know, they'll get a piece of the action. They'll do all the heavy lifting, and you sit back
and
just
Jew.
Be funny.
I'm going to get another Jew.
All right, listen, it's snowing out. Is this?
No, of course not.
Here in New York.
No, right? Nothing.
Here in New York, we love our snowstorms. I don't get it myself. I guess this happens all over the country where it does snow. The local news goes absolutely nuts every time it snows. And they talk to the people out there like they've never seen the damn thing before.
Yeah.
They've never seen snow before.
They like pumping it up,
you
making
know.
It bigger than it really is.
The news stations, the local news stations, I don't get it. When it snows, all of a sudden they make believe they're talking to people with Down syndrome.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, retards.
They just dumb it down to the lowest level, and they make believe you've never seen this white stuff before.
Same stories. Every time it snows, you got to have the reporter where it's snowing. She's got to talk to some people on the roads.
Right.
He or she. You got to have the weatherman talking about how, 2 days ago it looked like we were going to get hit. But thank God. They're always thankful when it doesn't hit us. But you know, in reality, they hate it because they're not going to be the stars of the news that night. When they get the big storms, the weather guy is the star of the news.
That's right. And they have to have a ruler and and just say stupid shit.
Ruler's good. They got to be standing somewhere where maybe there's a snow drift.
Right.
There's nothing worse than a disappointing snowstorm, too, when you sleep. That 8 hours is supposed to be a storm, and you open, like, you want to go. You want to have that fear, like, oh.
Yeah, oh, that was
damn.
A bad one.
Woo!
Not even a
look at this is
you
crazy.
You do get disappointed.
You're disappointed if you have nothing to do the next day, you know? If you have a day off and you know you're just hanging out watching DVDs, you want it to snow like a motherfucker.
It's
kind of
cool because it's an adventure if you have to go out.
Yeah, of course.
I
That's
love bad
nice.
Weather, man. I'm one of those guys.
Hurricanes.
I really love a lot of rain, a lot of snow.
Yeah.
Really, it just gives you an excuse to be lazy. Like, when it's nice, you have to,
you feel like I have to do something.
I got
to
get on out the house. But when it's, I love it.
Yeah.
It's just like,
well,
you know.
wake up after the 8 hours they say it's going to be a big blizzard, and you see grass poking up through a little dusting.
Yeah. Right. You just want it to be, when it was like, when last happened? Year when we was having them, all those storms, you just go, oh, woo, I love this. I love people getting stuck in their cars.
You got to keep looking out the window and telling whoever's there, it's accumulating. You see it out there? I just looked like 15 minutes ago, there's another inch or two. It's amazing how fast this is piling up.
Well, Nathaniel's been watching the local TV stations here in New York, and they're making a big deal out of nothing. So we got some examples of the reporters out there in the snowstorm.
Let's take a look at the parking lot here in the Monmouth Rest Stop on the Garden State Parkway, where you can tell over the past couple of hours that some snow is accumulating, and in some places it wasn't. The blacktop being just warm enough, it seems, and especially where cars were traveling over it, to pretty much melt it off. That's kind of like the way I saw it on the Garden State Parkway as I was driving over here. Places where you could see plenty of blacktop, the plows having success, the sand, and other places where it wasn't quite so obvious.
What? Oh.
Like I said. Despicable.
They're talking to us like we have Down syndrome all of a sudden.
I wonder if they go to themselves, that fucking Mother Nature. She screwed us again.
Nathaniel?
I feel like they try to come up with these new ways of saying it didn't snow that much.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what it is, because that isn't good.
Yeah.
They don't want to say that. It pains them to have to get on the next day and go, well, not really a lot of snow in our area. So what they do is they go, some areas did get up to 6 inches of snow, and it has nothing to do with the area that news is covering.
Yeah.
They're talking about, like, Jersey by Pennsylvania and like, upstate New York and Montauk Point. Like, some places in our area, if our area is, like, you know, 100-mile radius.
If the snow stuck on the ground, it would have been 8 inches. We have an accumulation bucket that we freeze so the snow accumulates in the bucket.
Yes.
There's 8.5 inches. Now, imagine that. Imagine if you were driving through that, huh?
Shut your eyes, if you will. Imagine your car covered in snow this morning.
They talk like the cars driving on the snow, like, we're lucky that the cars happen to be driving on the roads today because that melted the snow nicely.
Well, thank goodness.
Well, because that's what happens every time.
Yeah.
Now that it's the year 2005. More audio.
In Bayville, it was about 3 inches of snow on the ground, but once you got on the parkway, it was really more wet than anything else. But now as I'm coming up into Wall Township, it's starting to stick more.
Yeah.
So it's a little bit more slippery up this way.
He talked about using his all-wheel drive and saying he didn't think he'd have any problem, but, you know, you can't forget, four-wheel drive doesn't really matter when you hit something slick or slippery. It doesn't help you at all. Four-wheel drive is to get through the snow drift, not the snow slick.
Shut up.
So you could still die.
Shut up. The four-wheel drive is working just fine.
Why?
Shut up.
Yeah. Yeah, I think four-wheel drive, better than two.
Four-wheel drive,
no.
Pretty much not a problem.
Call me silly.
Fucking assholes. They're talking to us like we're retarded. Well, now we got the ruler check.
I know you've all been waiting for this to see how we're doing on our snow count, so here it goes, the official ruler of WNBC, and we're almost up to 4.5 inches right now. Chris is right on the money when he talks about the locally heavy snow down here. And I guess that's pretty much what we're looking at through the rest of the morning.
Doesn't it sound like he wants to say, someone please just kill me?
Just
shoot me.
It's just so well, it's
I had dreams of being a broadcaster growing up, and now I'm measuring fucking snow with a ruler.
Some people, some say that in blizzard conditions, some of the flakes are the same. And we're here to find them.
And there is such a little dusting here, we can actually go through every single snowflake here in the city today.
So much accumulation. Look, the same. We have twin snowflakes.
But it was a perfect recipe for a big snowstorm. But what we're seeing is really not that bad out here in Amityville, Long Island. Take a look behind me here on Route 110. The roadway conditions out here are slick, but not that bad. Just a little sloshy. People are definitely taking it easy. We found, if we could go to the video that we shot just a few moments ago, we found Christopher Ray Dice scraping his car this morning like most people, relieved that it wasn't that bad this morning. Again, just a few inches of accumulation. Most roadways, they don't look that bad out here. Again, just slow down, take it easy. It's because municipal garages are working overtime to keep our roadways safe.
You know what's looking bad? Iraq. Give us some real updates, you assholes.
Yeah, that looks bad.
They mean
that
looks bad. Told you it's Iraq, dude.
That looks bad. They're spending a lot of time on something that's not going
blizzard
on.
Blizzard that no one would even care about if there was a blizzard.
If there even was.
Like, I'm telling you.
They actually went to the tape of a guy scraping his windshield.
They said scraping, and he wasn't. He was brushing.
He was just brushing some flaky snow.
He had
snow.
A brush.
You know, that type of snow where it just takes one little brush and you're done.
Like,
he was drawing wash me with his finger.
This man is scraping his car. Scraping is when you're out there and it's like 0 degrees.
This is how bad the snow was, exactly.
Sir,
done.
Sir, what's going on? Are you having a heart attack? No, I'm just cleaning up my car.
A foo. If a foo could take care of the problem, it's not really snowing.
And, you know, I got to wonder if she asked him, do you have a scraper? Could you, like, brush the car off? Because that any other human just looks and goes... It just drives away.
Yeah.
You just turn on your windshield wipers so you can see, and you drive away, and that snow blows off your car.
There you go.
Even if it actually did, like, happen.
Yeah.
What? We don't give a shit. Like, even if it was the blitz, you
who
shouldn't
cares?
Even be out
right.
there. We know the deal.
We know the rules.
There's some salt coming.
Yeah.
There's
plows coming eventually.
Some people
we spoke with the mayor's office, and he said all the plows and salters are ready to roll.
The plows and salters are ready to roll.
So they do. All right, good here. I'm here outside the sanitation department. You see the trucks behind me leaving with the plows on.
We need day after tomorrow kind of weather.
Right.
To
Ice
care.
Age.
If somebody says, hey, look. There's going to be 10 feet of snow. The only way it would matter is if it all fell at once. Like, just, like, not flakes.
10-foot blanket.
Just a 10-foot blanket of snow. That would be some shit.
Get in the basements, people.
It's
this is going to be
coming,
serious.
It's all coming, baby. Right now. 8 inches of accumulation right this second. It's like, other than that, flakes, even if it was 10 feet, it's like,
God, ooh. You make a great point. Because even a blizzard, it's like, well, all right, now it's an inch.
Yeah.
Then the 20.
There it is.
Maybe
boy,
an hour,
this is creeping.
Maybe
up.
An hour goes by. Ooh, we're up to an inch and a half now.
And people panic like.
You're so right, but if it dumped 8 inches right away.
Right now.
I'd be fucking scared.
It would be a foot of snow right. immediately. There ain't right no flakes, baby. It's a blanket.
In the 30s or so 40s, right, I'm sure it was a problem when they had blizzards because they didn't have, like, a bunch of snow plows and things and the salting machines. Now, even a blizzard. The streets are plowed. You don't have to stock up on food.
Right.
You can get out of your house that day, later in the day.
And they start like, at 5. If the blizzard's coming at 10, they start.
Yep.
That's how you know this. They knew this wasn't going to be one because those things start and they're just pushing snow.
Yeah.
And snow never accumulates in New York because there's never not traffic to drive over the snow. Stop!
It's hitting the tops of the cars. And where it's hitting in between the cars are running it over anyway.
That's
and melting
right.
it.
We're trying to be scared.
And it comes in so slow that you got plenty of time to take care of everything you might need.
All
just like
once.
The hurricane thing. Hurricanes come in so slow, you got plenty
you
of time
see
to try
coming,
to figure it
get
out
the fuck
for
out.
You and your family.
It's
not like a tornado.
But man,
the tornado, like, all of a sudden there's a thunderstorm, the shit comes out of the sky,
blam!
Eats your farm up, and then it's gone. Now that's scary weather.
It's scary.
That's scary weather.
It's scary. But there's nothing that a blizzard would do.
Yeah.
Let's say 20 feet of snow.
20 right. feet.
If you're in your house and everything's cool, 20 feet of snow, you would not be afraid of 20 feet. You'd look and go, wow, man, there's snow outside my
20
window.
20 feet of snow, yeah.
But you're still, all you're really concerned about is cable cutting off. That's it.
Yeah, exactly.
There's no fear to snow. Sorry.
No.
There's nothing we have here that relates to anything that happens to some of these crackers in Tornado Alley. And
a great way to look at it, like a tornado, if you put it to music, it would be like Metallica or something. Just something just like
crazy.
Crazy. But a snowstorm, what kind of music would you put to the, you know,
all the weather outside.
Exactly.
That music. But the fire is so. Christmas music. It's snow music is not like, watch out! Right. Oh, yeah! Woo! And none of that. It's like,
exactly.
2 inches.
But a tornado, it's all about Metallica. Yeah! Even sounds like snow falling. Yeah.
People love when it snows.
It's beautiful.
It's not something scary, because especially on Christmas, around Christmas, people are like, oh, it's snowing. People enjoy snow. It's not like, oh, it's, you know, a Halloween tornado.
Right.
People are happy.
How scary can it be if there's songs called, like, Let It Snow, Let It Snow.
You're not hearing.
If little tornadoes came down in flakes, if tornadoes were in flakes, it might, you know what I mean? Like, little burst of wind is just coming down, hit me.
If tornadoes are coming, you're not singing a song, Let It Blow, Let It Blow. You know what I mean?
Oh, my trailer is not screwed down.
They're saying, Let It Snow.
Yeah, snow.
That's how scary snow is. Let it snow. I'll say it 3 times.
Even way, somewhere over the...
Here's
snow music.
Ah.
Don't try to scare us, News.
You can see the snow falling.
The weather outside is frightful.
Oh, it's frightful, but I'll... Inside, the fire's delightful. Frightful rhymes are delightful.
No place same song for a tornado.
The weather outside is
frightful. Oh, my God.
And this is a white guy who's on vacation.
Doesn't show signs of stopping. I brought some corn for popping.
Couldn't sound more relaxed.
No, he's falling asleep.
Let it snow.
But, sir, it's going to be 12 inches.
I don't fucking care. Put trees.
How I'll hate going.
Maybe 2 feet.
But if you really hold me tight.
Just a hug.
All the way home, I'll be.
Doesn't matter.
See? The fire is slowly dying. And my
that plane is throwing a tornado.
That's what I'm saying.
But as long as you love me so.
Let us have 350 mile an hour winds.
The only tornado song that was peaceful, Somewhere Over the Rainbow, that was
that picked her up and let her down real nice.
That's snow music right there.
Yeah, hell yeah. All right, we got more audio here. Let's go to the next one. This is a female reporter.
Now, people we spoke with getting their morning coffee this morning say they have mixed emotions about all of this snow.
I really don't think it was bad as everybody reported, so I'm kind of happy to be honest with you. Because at least this way I can go get my job done today and we can get through the streets, so it's really not that bad.
What do the roadways look like?
Oh, they're not bad. I thought it was going to be a lot worse. So I got to go into Queens now. Hopefully it's a lot better in there.
Their emotions sound mixed.
Well, the best part is they're all saying, I thought it was going to be a lot worse. Know why they thought it was going to be a lot worse? Because of the stupid news and their fear crap.
Thought it was going to be worse, but no, nothing.
If they didn't report that it was going to be storm, even if it wasn't that thing that blocks out your TV and goes, turn the channel. I got on my thing, turn the channel 35, because it's going to be a severe winter weather storm when it starts to go on the bottom.
Yeah.
If they didn't do that and you woke up to a surprise blizzard, you wouldn't know not what to do. You wouldn't go, oh, no.
How the fuck do I get through this?
Well, I got to put on my other hat. It's like, you know what to do. You don't even report a big blizzard.
That's so true.
And again, what we're seeing is a steady kind of snow. Now, Eddie, if you can stay with me, I want to show you the accumulation out here with my notebook. I don't have a ruler like Brian does, but it's just a few inches that we're seeing out here right now as we speak. And again, mixed emotions. People love it or they hate it.
By the way,
back to you in the studio.
We watched that clip. As she's saying, it's just a few inches. It was barely an inch.
Barely an inch of dusting, and she took her notebook and just kind of went, whoosh, whoosh.
She sounded like she was removing her clothing as it was... All right. right. Well, I had this little scarf on, but my neck is sweating, y'all.
Ooh, it's getting hot.
Oh, no. Now
and she tells the cameraman, if you can stay with me, yeah, through the blizzard-like winds, there's nothing happening.
Gotta love the camera guys. They've seen it all. They're like, stay with you. Jesus. Are you kidding me?
Stay with you. Don't worry about it.
Shot footage in Nam. This is nothing.
And, Darlene, I know you understand this. My hair is completely wet just standing out here for a few minutes. That's the kind of snow that we're experiencing. It's that slick, kind of slushy kind of snow.
Yeah, it's a bit of a mess, but you know what? We were saying earlier, you look absolutely beautiful.
Aw, Darlene, so I can always count on you to make me feel good.
Oh, shut up. It. This is why we do the assaults on the media.
Holes even in the news.
They stink. She's talking about her hair getting wet from the snow.
If you can look, that's the worst thing she could find.
Right.
She tried with the notebook. That wasn't really working. She wasn't showing the potential for danger or anything. The most dangerous thing she could find is that if you go out in this,
yeah,
your hair's going to get a little damp.
Get a little wet.
Why? That's it.
Why is not that bad news?
Yeah. Like, it's not that bad. Well... Then they shouldn't even have reported it.
Yeah.
Because they hyped it a little bit too much beforehand. So now they got to go on and go, ah, we're here, but it really is nothing like we said it might.
What do you got on Fox here? This slushy Ave, not ocean Ave?
She just makes a terrible joke. You could probably stop it right after the joke.
Oh.
Hi, Chris. Well, drivers tell us, you know what, this isn't too bad. Maybe I'm the baby. I'm the sissy in all of this. But they tell us it isn't too bad, and the plow truck drivers, they've been doing a good job clearing this road. This is Ocean Avenue. It looks more like Slushy Avenue out here in Seabright. Hey, how you doing? They're honking at us. Everyone is pretty much taking their time, and drivers tell us they hope everyone does that for the rest of the day because the snow is still falling.
Nah, you know what? I think this time around the driver's going to, you know, try to go 100 miles an hour.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think they finally had it, and they're going to see what their car could do in this
in this
mess.
Open it up
just
on the icy road.
Of course they're going to take their time.
Is still falling, and it started coming down right around midnight over here on the coastal areas. Residents tell us the town's snow plows have been doing a good job clearing the side streets, the highways as well, looking pretty good as well. Our drive down here was pretty smooth. The state's transportation department actually has more than 300 snow plows carrying salt and sand, and that's just for the turnpike. There are one...
All right, enough. Exactly. The
rush
idea.
Hour could be a mess. We'll keep you informed. Like, no, it isn't. It isn't a mess. Sorry. Sorry we panicked you.
There you go. It's just another bust.
I love that. Let it snow. No one cares.
You know what? The Today Show could go fuck themselves.
Ooh. Wow.
This is why we have no respect for the media whatsoever. Because they don't get anything right.
Nothing.
Yeah, we'll get them after the commercial. This was on the Today Show just a little while ago.
Well, on January 9th, Stern will become the first shock jock in space when he takes his sophomoric shtick to Sirius Satellite Radio. With only
eight
shows...
Hey, you cunt. What are we, Wicker? You motherfucker.
Well, you know what? I guess it's time to start assaulting the Today Show again.
Yeah.
It's time to assault the Today Show.
It's time to maybe inform Katie that we've been here over a year. Yeah, how about that? Over a year.
This is what the media does all the time.
Mm-hmm.
They don't like us. They're not happy with us.
Nope.
We've pulled some of our shenanigans and...
Always the bastards.
And made them look silly a few times. Our most famous one was when a girl flashed her breasts on the Today Show Live.
Mm-hmm.
Became an international story. They know about us.
How about now Gash?
And, you know, we weren't a tiny little radio show when we were on commercial radio. We were syndicated. We were doing well. We were getting, you know, national headlines, international headlines. And everyone knows we're the first ones to come to satellite radio.
No respect.
Everyone knows that. We've been here a year and 3 months.
Yeah.
I don't, you know, but they just go on the air and just blatantly lie mm-hmm. about this.
Only eight shows left on his terrestrial radio show. Howard's been getting surprisingly sentimental.
It has been a spectacular 20 years.
Radio's raunchiest DJ even apologized recently to his audience for what he called 10 years of subpar broadcast, laying the blame squarely at the feet of the Federal Communications Commission.
Yeah, just proving that you can't do a radio show unless you're being dirty, Howard.
Yeah.
That's it. 10 years. Wow. Apologize. Waddle doodle. I apologize.
He's blaming the FCC on 10 years of bad radio. And coincidentally, the last 10 years is when Anthony and I became massive radio stars.
Yeah.
Under the same rules and
the
same eyes of the Federal Communications.
We had no problems right up until they threw our asses out.
And we also got fined and all that, but we had to adjust. And guess what? We became very, very popular in the last 10 years, as Howard is admitting that he couldn't do a show under those conditions. He's going to stink on satellite radio. And fucking the Today Show. We're the first to do it. Everyone knows it. For them to blatantly lie like that, payback's going to be a bitch.
Yeah, you watch. Have fun. Bitches.
The Army, you know, they got a lot of projects they're working on, but,
the money they're paying him, is it from who they automatically believe that everybody's going to just come?
That's part of it,
I'm sure. Do they already know that it might not be as many whatever?
That and commercials.
No one can figure out how it's a good deal for that company. No one. No one on Wall Street can figure
Wall
it out.
Wall Street can't figure it out.
No one can figure out how they're going
to
make money.
It's anticipated, though, money. It has to be, right?
Well, the reality
it's not guaranteed.
The reality is, too, there's more people that will not get satellite radio because he's over there. You know what I mean? It's a whole clusterfuck. Hmm. There are people that will now buy XM because he's going over there. That's a fact. That's just how it works.
Yeah.
Why is that?
No one could figure out how this is a good deal for them. That's a good deal for the industry, though.
Why is that? Why is that more people buy XM because he's going to Sirius?
Because XM has the better programming in general, and then, you know, that could be the turnoff. You know, there was a, what was the car maker that's decided?
Oh, I see what you're saying. Like, he's leaving, so he's like, you know what? If I'm going to go to satellite, I'm just going to go to XM.
I'm going to go to XM.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Okay.
But just a note for the past and the ONA Army, you know, keep the Today Show on your radar. Mm-hmm. I know you're working on some big projects now, but when you're ready, I think they need to realize that we were the first to come to satellite radio.
Teach him a lesson, a nice old lesson.
Oh, we'll teach him a lesson. No problem.
Lesson.
Oh, no problem. The media in general is very, very scared of this radio show. You'll see.
Petrified.
You'll see.
Well, now, will you let her off the hook if like, Katie Couric gets on and goes, yesterday we forgot to acknowledge that.
We have a correction.
ONA was the first one to go.
We have a correction.
Dude, it's just lying.
Call your people off, fellas. Thanks.
It's just lying through your teeth. This isn't like a gray area like, wow, are Opie and Anthony shock jocks? Were they popular on commercial radio? We were a high-profile show on commercial radio that did, quote, shocking things. You know, and we made headlines. All the stuff that Howard's going through right now. To some extent, we did all those same interviews, said the same shit. We were in the magazines. We were on the TV.
Mr. A, can you do me a favor? Could you have some of your listeners stop pressing their asses against the window in the morning?
It's really hard to do the news.
We can't be serious with an ass cheek.
No, you know what? We're going to have a special project for the Today Show. There's going to be a special project for the Today Show.
Oh, man.
Oh, yeah.
we don't
mess around, though.
We don't miss a thing. We were the first
motherfuckers.
We're
just stupid. A year and 3 months ago, everyone was admitting we were the first ones to satellite radio. Mm-hmm. That's why we start our show almost every morning saying you're listening to the pioneers of satellite radio.
Well,
Doug, you're listening, right?
There's some
when you can.
There are some nude butt cheeks coming forth.
That's great. Anthony, with all the Christmas songs playing and all the snow, are a bunch of white guys finally waking up in New York City hospitals. That's right. If you got asked for directions in July on the street, if you were a tourist maybe, just some poor white guy, and you went and some guy came up to you and said, yo, man, which way is north? And you turned and pointed. You should just be regaining consciousness right now.
Is that a true story or is that some dance?
That is somebody that was asked for directions and was mugged.
Yeah.
And we kind of went off, and we did it during the summer, that if that happens, if you're walking down the street and someone asks for directions, I usually just act like a lunatic. Like, I'll be walking and someone goes, excuse me, I'll go, don't even! Like, and throw my arms up and keep walking.
Fucking realize that robbing somebody like that is almost like tapping somebody on the right shoulder and being on the left.
It always starts with a conversation. It always starts with, hey, man, you know what time it is? And then while you look at your watch, all of a sudden, everything goes black, and then your family is around you, and you hear, ding, 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 ding. And you don't know what happened. You're like, wait, wasn't it just 90 degrees? And why is it snowing out?
Here's what you do. All you have to do to not get robbed when somebody's in school is act like you know what the hell you're talking about. Or make it quick. I don't know. But don't scratch your head and try to help too much.
No,
then they know you're not from
right.
Around.
But I don't even take that chance. I just go, I don't even know. I throw my hands up. I don't even. Don't even.
La, la, la.
I know what you're all about.
But then that makes me want to rob you because it's like, this fucking asshole.
No, because it's an easy mark. They're lazy motherfuckers. They don't want to, like chase me down
or try
to get into my psyche. They'll find some roof that goes, well, I don't know. I'm new to the city here and pop.
Jingle bell rock.
Oh, here it is. Here it is.
I have an example.
Oh, you do? Actually.
Let's see.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, which way is north?
Oh, well, let me see. It's right.
That's what happened. It was just summer. What? Mom? Dad? What are you doing here? And where am I?
Why is there a Christmas tree in this room?
I remember I was...
Which way is north?
I was going to go to the beach that day.
What?
It was so hot.
If somebody said north, they're not smart enough to ask for where's north. Like, it's...
Why is there a Christmas tree in my room with all these cards?
You woke up, exactly.
Why is the doctor dressed as Santa?
Why are the Santa hat? It's July, right?
It's seagulls.
That's your cell phone call. That's your call right before that happens.
Yeah. You go.
Yeah, Bobby. No, I'll see you at the beach, man. I know it's fucking hot. No, I'm leaving work early, and I'll see you down there. Yeah, we'll meet the girls down at the beach. I know. No, fucking blazing. I'm looking forward to jet skiing. All right, man. I'll see you later. Take it easy.
Yeah, which way is north?
Oh, well, let me see. It's right.
But I'm supposed to go jet skiing with Bobby. What? What? What is this? Christmas in July? Radio promotion? What's...
Rest, dear.
What? Rest from what? I don't remember anything. Wait a minute.
Just rest,
I do remember
dear.
It was hot and something about north and then everything went black.
Oh, my God. You woke up in Christmas. I didn't even get that shit. Boom.
That's how it happened.
That is frightful.
You wake up, he had tan and lotion on.
Yeah, you think they shower you down or they wait for you to wake up. And then you take the six-month shower that you need.
Oh.
Your family's got to bring in new clothes because you can't possibly leave in what you got there in because it was shorts and a T-shirt.
Oh, my God, you wake up on Christmas.
That's
time.
It. It's Christmas.
Oh,
all right. We're going to do some bear hunting. Everyone else is doing the bear hunting. We got the audio of the stories. We'll do that next, okay?
People up in arms on both sides of the bear hunt.
Oh, shut up.
Ugh.
It's some of the audio, though, is very, very entertaining. As we go to break, Dennis Leary was in here very recently, and he did a Christmas special for Comedy Central. Very, very funny, very dark, very edgy, got away with a lot of stuff. And we got a little taste of the show he did for Comedy Central.
Roy
has Tourette's.
Oh, yeah?
And he's going to come in here and actually do a stand-up. We're going to make the studio look like a comedy club.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. We'll have an announcer and all that crap.
And Tourette's has got to be a bitch.
What the hell is
Tell those guys we'll talk to him right after this, right at the end of this break. All right, you know what? We'll get him going right now. Hey, Josh, what's going on?
Hey, how's it going?
All right, man. I'm trying to get your partner on the other line. Who's on the other line here?
This is Char.
Char?
Hi.
Oh, it's a chick. Oh. All right.
It is a chick.
A chick.
Yeah, chicks.
All right. Very cool. Why are you calling us today? You guys are... Oh, I know why. You guys are opening up for Bon Jovi tonight?
We are opening up for Bon Jovi.
How did that come about?
Oh,
thanks to you guys.
To us personally?
Someone gave us a phone call and said, we're opening up for Bon Jovi.
I guess Bon Jovi's doing this, like, this contest where they're getting bands, unsigned bands, to warm up for them all over the country.
Right on. That's warm up. That's about right. Have a nice gig, I think the contest is called.
Hey, that's pretty cool.
We know she's the girl, but the guy, which one of you guys is the guys looking off into the... Everybody's looking off into the distant...
Yeah, we got your band shot.
That's cool, man.
That is the band shot.
Over there.
Yeah.
I set that camera up myself on a tripod. I ran over, and I'm like, all right, look into the sunset.
Just look in different directions, man. It shows how multifaceted we are musically, because we're all looking off into different directions. Man,
dude, our band is so cool. We don't look into the camera.
Vertical horizon, man.
Why aren't
horizon,
you holding,
man?
One guy should be like holding his fist up, though, and the drummer should be holding his sticks in a V. Rock.
I saw this group on VH1 the other day.
Yeah.
Some little they was on the big old five, and they were all fat little dudes. It was the first chubby fat little rock group I've ever seen. Just
they'll never make it if they're coming.
What are the name of those? What's the name of that group? Just a bunch of fat kids.
Fat kids.
And then at the end, he threw his guitar into the drum set. I didn't even think they did shit like that.
They don't. Hey, why didn't you put what's your name, girly?
Char.
Why?
As in car, only SH.
All right. How many times do you have to say that every day? Why didn't they put you up front in the picture?
Because she's not the lead singer.
I'm the lady.
No,
right?
What are you playing in the band?
I play the bass guitar.
Oh, you're the bass player?
Yeah, that's why she's in the back.
All right, then you should be in the back.
You should be only half seen.
Isn't it cute when the bass player picks up the guitar player's guitar and shows him what he knows or she knows on guitar? And it's just, like, so adorable. Oh, look, the two extra strings.
How far are these guys away? Are they on the cusp of something, man?
Hey, listen. Josh, I'm hanging up on you because are you on a speakerphone? Are you on a speakerphone, Josh?
No.
Well, your phone stinks. It's echoing all over the place.
Wow, it's really echoing.
Really messing up this interview.
I'll go in the other room. Does that work better?
Wow.
Where are you calling from?
Is he calling
from a gym?
We are out in the middle of the woods.
Oh, you're in the middle of the woods.
I know, the cusp of fame. These guys are these guys.
Well, let's try to figure this out. They're opening up for Bon Jovi tonight in Pittsburgh, right? XM ran some kind of contest. Is that what's going on?
Yep.
Or did Bon Jovi themselves run this contest?
No, I think XM ran it for Bon Jovi, but Bon Jovi has always been a guy who supports the up-and-coming.
Yeah, because he's still up and coming. Bon Jovi. Whoa.
You gotta have respect for Bon Jovi because he's still up and coming. He's been in the business for a long time.
Ah, bitch, he ain't LL.
LL.
He ain't LL Cool J and nothing like that. He ain't Run DMC.
Bon Jovi's doing better than ever these days.
Is he really?
Oh, my God, they are.
Is he like, is he has a YouTube thing or a...
No, not as big as U2, but they're still...
Run DMC.
Huh?
As big as you too?
Why are your phones echoing? You're driving me nuts.
Now she's got like a double speak thing going.
Yeah.
I don't hear any echoes.
All right, now you're okay again. So the name of the band is Kairos?
Kairos.
And what do you guys sound like?
Progressive rock. Muse, Deftones, Perfect Circle.
I see.
Explain that to black people.
It says here songs range from 5 to 12 minutes.
Right.
And take a listener through a whirlwind of emotions, man. Who wrote that?
Iraqi war is bad.
We're the new Dream Theater.
Who wrote that?
Hussein ain't right.
Not the new Dream Theater.
Who wrote Whirlwind of Emotions? I want to reach into that picture and choke you.
We take you through fear.
Whirlwind of Emotions. I went to see Kairos, man, and I was scared at first. Then I was fucking happy. Then I just got fucking pissed, and then I was laughing. It was a whirlwind of emotion.
That's right.
Then I was on minute 23 of the first song. No, you guys really have long songs?
Yeah. We're doing that one tonight.
Is it like cool songs, though, when they're long, or you know, you're not doing
what do you guys sing about?
Live version of Green Grass and High Tides, are you?
Hey, that's a
good song.
Yeah,
I like it.
Yeah, yeah. If you got like an hour to kill,
or you have a big attention span.
Greengrass and High Tides Forever is great if it's if you're skating with a chick at the roller rink.
Right, and you really like her.
Yeah, and you really like her. You don't want the song to end.
You
want to
touch her for a long time.
Right, it's the last song before they have to reverse skate, and you know you only got a few minutes and close the deal.
What level are these guys at?
I don't know, man. How long you guys been playing?
Probably about 4 years altogether. We just picked up Shar less than a year ago. So,
who'd you have as a bass player? What dick asshole that you threw out of the band did you have before that?
He had to quit. His mom pulled him out of the band. He was
he was an ass anyway.
Who was it? The guy? Yeah.
Wait, why did the mom pull the bass player out of the band? Sounds like there's a story there.
She wanted to go to college, and she knew we were serious. We were going to pursue this. So,
she was on a whirlwind of emotion when she pulled him out.
I hope you guys become the next Nirvana, man. That guy's going to fucking eat a shotgun.
Who was it? Constantine? Was it? Oh, Constantine.
Constantine was in a band, and he left to be on a loser on American Idol.
What happens if you guys get really famous and the whole groupie thing starts? What are you going to do with her? What are you going to do with Char?
Like, how are you going to handle?
Wait outside and practice, baby.
Yeah, who's girlfriend?
She's married to the singer, Jason.
Okay. Oh, that must be great for the other two guys in the
pussy
band.
Pussy whip rock and roll stars. There's nothing worse. Kurt Cobain is he's twisting in his grave right now.
What's that? I got to know what the relationships are here. So,
okay, the lead singer, Jason, he's my brother.
Yeah.
Oh, boy. All right, the brother. So it's your brother's chick.
This is a Christian band,
It's a cult. It's a fucking Christian rock band. It's a cult. It's a goddamn
whirlwind of emotions. I got it now.
So who's odd man out that isn't related in some way?
Well, he's related. It's Drew. He's our drummer. We've lived with him for like 4 years, so he's blood now.
Yeah.
All right, so we got a couple brothers.
He doesn't have as much pull or say because now, not just because he's the drummer, but because he's not like tight like you guys.
No drugs.
No, that's like that. He's just as much a part of the band as we are.
Are you bitchy at all, Char?
Not really.
Char, here's the very important question.
That'll break a bit.
Char, here's the very important question. If the band makes it, there's going to be that whole groupie scene. Are you going to allow your man to have a little taste? Just a little taste, you know? He's got to live the rock and roll lifestyle.
Huh?
Just a little trim on the side?
A little bit.
Little backstage,
just so he can feel like a rock star.
Yeah, how uncomfortable she is about that. It's all, dude. Get rid of her. Why would you bring your wife into a progressive rock group band? What is wrong with you guys?
I'm not really.
We don't do drugs. We get our anger just from the world, man. Katrina gives us our anger.
All right, what are the songs about, guys?
What song are you gonna play?
No, well, I don't know. What song we got there?
What song
there?
We got?
We got a song called Saturate. Saturate!
Let's see how I can over-politicize this.
What's Saturate about?
Our interpretation of our experiences with the world in musical form. How's that?
Oh, my God. I want to choke you.
Let me tell you what she can't wait for. She can't wait to win an award so she can give a speech. Let me tell you something. Throw your peace signs up, everybody.
Everybody. You know what was a great song? Safety Dance. I like it. Safety Dance. Safety Dance.
Always bring your Kairos lighters to the show because there is going to be a lighter moment here.
That's fantastic.
Oh,
we're just goofing, obviously. Let's listen to Saturate. Let's see what this is about.
I want to hear some Saturate.
This is Kairos, our new friends that are opening up for Bon Jovi tonight in Pittsburgh. You play the pen very well, by the way.
there's a taste of Kairos.
All right.
And Saturate. What do you think, Anthony?
All right.
Anthony's been in bands his whole life. Let's see what Anthony has to say.
I think they're pretty good. I like that. I like the, man, a lot of production in that. You guys spent a lot of time in the studio, huh?
Actually, 2 weeks. 2 weeks.
That's it?
That's 2 weeks. 2 weeks. That's all we had.
Jesus.
Not bad.
Goddamn modern equipment. Try doing it on tape, you bastards.
Goddamn computers.
That's right. Pro Tools.
Goddamn Pro Tools, yes.
A lot of practice, 18-hour days, and Pro Tools. That's what it was.
18-hour days.
All right.
Definitely lost our equipment as well.
Anything over four.
My equipment got stolen on the way to the studio. We flew out to California because we knew a guy out there. All my guitar stuff got stolen on the way.
That blows.
Yeah, it's got to happen to every band.
So everything was borrowed.
All right. Well, you got the big night tonight in Pittsburgh opening up for Bon Jovi.
Heck yeah.
Oh, we got another publicity shot of you guys.
How's this one?
Char is leaning her head on her man.
She's wearing a tie, man.
Oh, Char. Uh huh.
Yeah, that guy on the left. The guy on the left, man. Listen, Char, don't cock block his like booby stage. Because this guy really, like the one on the right, looks like he tried to be cool.
Yeah.
Hey, that's me.
But
Jesus.
Is that you?
Patrice?
Yeah, with the goddamn fake fan that blows the coat and the hair to the side. But the guy on the left needs some pussy. Don't blow it for him by being all, don't do that to women. Don't belittle women. Let him belittle some women. Get him some ass. This guy's going bald, a balding rock and roll star. Give this guy a break. When he's getting
Patrice.
Some ass. You two lovers.
These are our new friends, Kairos.
I'm just saying, don't ruin his good rock and roll time, okay?
If these guys blow up.
I'll do my best.
These guys blow up huge, they're never going to be on our show again because of nasty things that Patrice has said.
I'm just saying.
Yeah, we don't know Patrice. He's just a comic that's promoting a gig.
The two lovebirds. Don't ruin the balding guy on the left's
ride. Opie fucked up our relationship with Godsmack.
I certainly
before
did.
They made it. I don't want that to happen again.
Let me tell you a little story about Godsmack. All right, listen. But we love Godsmack. We're big fans of theirs.
Sonny Farrelly's loving it. He says, not bad. I laughed. I cried. I shit my pants. So it's a whirlwind of emotion. No, people are liking it.
So was that good? I couldn't. I'm not even trying to be funny. I couldn't. It sounds.
He's
good
a black
to me.
Guy. Understand? He can't really understand that kind of music.
It sounded good to me, but you know how people who are real fans of rock and roll. They go, nah, that was that.
No, it's alright.
Was it good?
I saw some woman, some black woman comic at the Apollo commenting, and this is going back a few years, on how white people don't understand hip hop music.
Mm-hmm.
And then she goes into this tirade about Nirvana. And talking about how that music is just the worst, and she's trying to, I don't know, make fun of it.
She picked the wrong group.
She absolutely picked the wrong fucking group. Like, she had no clue.
You don't cross racism.
Right.
Just stick to what white people don't know about you, but don't dip into white. Like, I
don't
know if that's good. Because I might have tried to have been funny and go, that was But
you don't know.
I really don't
know. And I'm not going to try to dip into hip hop and tell you this shit sucks or this is great stuff or that because I'll just end up looking
to
me. Stupid.
Right.
All hip hop sounds
the same. And I can go ahead and know that sounds good.
Stick to your racism.
It was haunting. Right. Can I say that?
Haunting.
That
haunting.
Song just
that is good.
It was haunting.
That's all
right. Is that good? That's good, right?
I think that's a compliment.
How long is that song?
Yeah, how many minutes?
5 minutes?
6 minutes.
Oh, 6 minutes?
So it's right under there.
One of the short ones.
All right. Well, guys, what are we promoting today? Obviously, the gig in Pittsburgh with Bon Jovi, but what about a website or something?
KairosBand.com.
KairosBand.com. And, well, you got, I don't know, man, if you're going to be giving out that plug, no one knows how to spell Kairos.
K-A-I-R-O-S Band.
Okay. And also you're on MySpace?
We are.
Everyone.
MySpace. .com/Kairos7.
It's just a slash. Everybody.
And look, and make sure my best wishes.
I hear that so many times when I listen to the radio. It's just a slash.
That's the slash everyone uses.
We just know it's a slash.
My best wishes to the guy in the band that looks like the one of the hobbits from. And also the Star of Lost. what's that guy's name?
He's the drummer.
We'll let him know.
One of the guys from Lord of the Rings, and he's in Lost. He stars in Lost. That guy, he looks like that guy.
The drummer.
My best wishes to him.
And Char.
Good luck to the group for him.
Look like.
Sharp, who do you look like?
I don't know. I don't know that anyone's ever asked me that before.
Well, why'd you steal Avril Lavigne's tie?
That is the first time and the only time I've ever worn a tie.
Really?
Yeah.
But who do people think you look like?
Honestly, I don't know. I guess I do kind of look like Avril Lavigne in that picture.
Very good. Okay. Well, good luck to you guys.
Thank you.
Yeah, have fun, man.
Enjoy the experience tonight. It's going to be great for you guys.
Yeah, we're going to have a blast.
All right, cool. There they go, Kairos, our new friends. Hey, let us know how it goes tomorrow.
Yes, sir. All right, we'll
will.
All right, yeah, give us a quick call tomorrow.
All right, cool.
All right, there they go, Kairos. All right.
Kairos.
So, it was a good song?
I think it's a hook. Maybe
it was
a...
Well, I think the type of music they do isn't like that, you know, chorus-verse, kind of...
I think the hook was covered.
Verse, chorus, kind of, you know, the hook and then the rest of the song and repeat it another time. And it's like all over kind of the place, man. Like Pink Floyd, I think they said, is compared to bands like Pink Floyd.
I heard a little Perfect Circle in there. A little bit.
Yeah, there was something else with the...
A little bit.
The vocals sounded a little familiar, but...
I was just thought the rock and roll. That's just like positive rappers, like Christian rappers.
Oof.
He's like, give it up for God, baby.
Oh,
yo,
no.
You know,
bring on the hose.
Keeping it real for Jesus. It's like like rock and roll bands to
keeping
me.
Keeping it real for
Jesus. Jesus is off the hook. I hate that shit. And it's like these rock and roll bands who are like, and the whoo, doodle doodle, these yodely. I just can't. I really was into Kurt Cobain. That was a bad dude to me.
Yeah.
And it's like some of these groups, but this yodely positivity thing where,
you know these serious
rock groups, you know, that don't do anything wrong. And
If I pop on K-Rock now or something and I'm listening, I go, my God, I cannot tell you what band this is based on who it sounds like. You know, I know because I just kind of know.
Yeah.
But the sound, it's so hard to come up with an original sound to a band and make it. You know, you could kind of be copies of other bands and the vocalist sounds the same or your music is kind of the same and get through and get picked up, get signed, go on tour, whatever. But something like a Nirvana where out of the blue you just come out and it's such a completely different fucking sound and you just go through the roof.
Bands on Ethel that sound like Nirvana.
I'm going to go on a limb and say this, that right now rock and roll music, white people's music is in a bad way, and I'm going to tell you why.
Yeah.
Because I knew about Nirvana. Nirvana stepped over... Kurt Cobain and them stepped into my life.
Yeah.
That's how big they were and how good they were. But these goofy...
You guys were wearing the flannels in the hood?
Music was so good that people just knew who Kurt Cobain...
Yeah,
but there's not one of these goofy groups now. Like, I didn't realize Green Day was still... I turn on something and Green Day's winning an award for
they're
best song.
Fucking,
I'm like, what?
They kind of went away for a little while. Not totally away, but they just came back.
This
huge.
Last album was just a monster
huge.
For them.
Huge.
The funny thing about Green
what
Day.
What are you guys talking about now?
Green Day.
What are white guys talking about? I'm saying,
music wise?
Music wise. What's your thing now?
It's all over the place.
Now?
It really is. There's no real. I mean, you got the standouts like U2 and things like that. White Stripes is one of my favorite bands.
What are they into?
Unbelievable.
Nirvana was into.
I like the Alkaline
Fuck
Trio.
The World kind of thing.
Yeah. Alkaline Trio.
There's really not a theme like a Fuck the World grunge type theme.
It's not a band really
anymore.
Just taking the lead right now.
I hate any of those bands that are like, I got up for work this morning and I didn't like it. It's any fucking of the 20 bands that sound like that.
My girlfriend broke up with me.
It's hard being poor and stupid. Today it's hard being poor and stupid. Like, it's, all right, we get it. My parents don't understand me. Oh, fuck you, shut up. And how many... There's either one that has 1,000 songs out, or there's 1,000 band one-hit wonders. I can't tell.
I don't think there's a parent out there that understands their kids.
Oh, God.
Let's stop singing about
that. Hopped in my old car, picked up my friends.
There was a sound for a minute I liked where, what was the one where the kid was walking on the beach, and he sounds like this. It's like, you know, the...
What?
Wow. How old are you going?
It's a bittersweet symphony.
Oh, that one.
Oh, yeah. The one with the cranberries. Oh, you remember the cranberries?
Linger?
Zombie. What's the one that...
Zombie.
It was in every white movie.
Hey, get my...
That sound for like a second.
There's something in there that relates to what we're talking about.
There was a sound, that yodeling sound for like a quick... It was the Cranberries thing. That little yodeling thing and that little creepy kind of high voice. For a second, that was the thing for like a quick, you know.
The song? No, I think he's talking about... This is Linger. I think he's talking about Zombie by the Cranberries.
The one...
Is it about the war? What? Fighting?
Fighting.
Yeah.
It's the theme song for all of those love...
This could be.
What I got? I got some cool...
Music back then.
Wait, here it is. Oh, wait, turn it off. Turn it off. Wait a minute.
Oh, my. Da, 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 da. Oh. Turn this totally down for a second.
I don't know the word, but it.
You know what that is? Let me punch. I know. It's ringing a bell. I'm going to instant feedback. You're absolutely right.
That's it right there. That sound was the shit for like, I don't know what it's out.
How does a black man know about this?
Wow. This is some underground white shit for you, black guy to know.
It's in every one of these, like, you know.
You're absolutely right.
You know,
yeah.
Angelica Houston is the mother, John Cryer is the sister. Starring Kate Hudson. Starring Colin Farrell. This is it, baby. That's the song.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, this was
that
huge.
Was the every one of those movies is that's the song right there. Whatever.
You know,
he's from Seattle. She's from Upper Wyoming.
They get together in this love story that's unpredictable.
God damn, you hit that one.
Oh, jeez.
You know what? Give Derek this list so we can do this after the break. One of the men's magazines did a article on the most annoying songs ever.
Annoying?
The most annoying
songs
ever.
Are they annoying, or can some of them be like guilty pleasure?
Most of them are very
annoying. Because I got to tell you, to this day,
yeah,
this is what, 2006
almost,
we're heading
almost
toward.
2006. Eh?
Well, we're a month away.
Yeah.
I will not turn off Wang Chung. I will not turn off
Wang
Everybody
Chung
Have Fun Tonight, Everybody
have
Wang
fun
Chung.
Tonight.
If I'm driving and I hit that goddamn 80s channel on XM and that goddamn Wang Chung song, it gets turned up and I get a smile and it's a happy song. Oh, here it is.
Oh, look at it.
There's no look, turning this
look,
off.
Look, he just smiled.
Da-da-da.
What makes you happier, this song or a Puggle?
Oh, wow.
That's a tough one.
Wow. That's rough, but I'll hold a Puggle while listening to this song, and he'll lick my face.
Dun, dun, dun. All's good with the world. This song's on the radio.
Hey! There's nothing wrong with the world. Right. You're in traffic. I don't care. What are you listening to? Because it's not Wang Chung. You're obviously angry.
All of a sudden, the construction workers are dancing on the sidewalk. They just
why,
gotta get
why
it to
not?
The moon.
Why not? And why not?
And it's choreographed.
All is right with the world. All of a sudden, the meter maid puts down her pen and pad. She's got to dance a little. There will not
Listen,
be.
It's great.
tickets today.
One of those videos where it starts off with one person and then a lot of people stop following you.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. Right. And everyone's caught up in it.
All changes sizes.
Oh, even
how do you not like this?
Even the dirty Arab in his cab is having a good time with this song.
With he blows himself up and he goes, ah!
He's dancing with a Jew. They love each other. This makes me want to sell my guns when I hear this.
There you go.
Very good.
The world is a happy place.
It's
a
telling everybody
place.
To have fun. Hmm. And you do.
We have another song that people will follow you if they hear it.
Uh-huh.
Oh, this is the one Anthony mentioned earlier. Right,
it is? Oh, the safety dance. What a horrid song.
You can dance if you want to. You can leave the world behind.
What was the name of this guy?
Men Without Hats.
Oh, it was Men Without Hats, right. I thought it was a guy.
And their follow-up song was
like Falco.
And their follow-up was that one song that...
Oh, that's right.
Pop Goes the World.
That's in the category of songs that never, ever would have gotten anywhere without MTV.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
All right, where's that list? We should do it real fast. I just gave it to Derek so he can play some of these songs. We got a break? We're rocking, man.
Take a break. Hey, Ben, you take a break.
I'm not taking no break.
Break a break you.
I guess we're selling some commercials, huh? Finally?
Hey, look at
us. I don't know what goes on when...
20 minutes of commercials.
That's right, Robin. Where's my Boy Scout uniform? Let's see. Oh, and we're going to have more tryouts for Tissue Time, by the way. Any women want to talk dirty today and do some phone sex, you got to give us a call. We got to do one before we get out of here today, okay?
Right.
A lot of people are requesting the old Tissue Time bit. Nathaniel?
Everything's great.
Why is everyone running around panicking? They're writing notes.
They do that to look busy.
Really?
Like, there are some Post-its that just say, like, Post-it. So they just write things.
Patrice, speaking of music, did we play Gangsta Fag for you yet?
No.
Oh, my God.
Oh, God.
Do we got stuff for you.
Gangsta Fag.
Do we have time to play a little Gangsta Fag at least?
I'm finally getting my XM radio turned on so I can goddamn know what the hell's going on these days.
Look at the post-it Than just posted for me.
Yeah. You're right.
It says, you're right.
Ass.
All right, we'll take a break. Make Ben happy.
Ah.
When we get back, this is what happens. We're going to do the most annoying songs of all time. We're going to do Gangsta Fag.
I bet I like the annoying songs deep down. I won't admit to all of them, but a couple I'll probably admit to.
There is a band on there that you absolutely love.
The reason they're annoying is because they get stuck in your head and they're catchy, probably.
Right.
Oh, there's one in there that I love? Is that a tease?
Yes.
Wow.
Yes, that's a tease, Anthony. And what else are we going to do? Oh, yeah, and then we're looking for the really hot-sounding girls to call in to do Tissue Time.
Right.
We're still looking for
our new
perfect
bit.
Yeah, the perfect person to do Tissue Time. And we got some dude with Tourette's that wants to do comedy before we get out of here, right? Is he almost ready? Shit, how are we going to get all this in? We finally decided 9:30 to do a radio show?
Chock full of bits.
This is the stupidest job ever. I got to finally admit it to everybody. You just come in here and make shit up, and you get paid boatloads of money.
And you know what's funny? That there is a person. Because, you know, you listen to the radio, and you get excited about things, and he goes, man, what the fuck are they talking? What happened to the bear hunting?
Yeah.
Like, there's somebody here.
They were
going to
talk about the bear hunt. You never got to it.
Nigga got into a noise song. You let that goddamn nigga sidetrack you with cranberries? We want to know about bears, nigga. Bears.
But hearing a big black dude talk about the cranberries, that's priceless, man.
Just trying to figure out what the fuck you were talking about. Oh, great.
You know, it's the song about the...
That's like us coming in here and trying to tell you that we discovered this great new rap guy named Jay-Z.
Or just trying to go, you know what song it is, you know, Patrice? What? It's the one where the guy goes, I don't know the words, but it's about the song of Mr. Bob, Mr. Bob, J-Bob, fuck,
wait a minute, but then I'll go, oh, I know that one.
Oh, I
that's
know that.
Called Choke This Hoe. Yeah, that's number six.
Choke This Hoe.
Y'all knew the cranberries. You go, oh, I knew it. He started playing the shit.
Listen, Sharon really needs to get on the air. Sharon from Pennsylvania, what's up?
Hey, I have to thank you guys, first of all. The way home from the gym yesterday, I was listening to the most original skit ever.
Thank you.
Beth and Allison.
Yes.
You guys are brilliant for coming up with that one.
Thank you. of course you're talking about Tissue Time.
Of course.
Ah,
yes. Yes.
And it sounds like you got very horny yesterday listening to that.
Absolutely.
You did.
I did. And my husband was in the car with me, and I told him, holy ass, this is getting horny right now. And went home, took a shower, banged the heck out of him. Thank you, Tissue Time.
Look at that.
There you go.
Tissue Time. We're getting couples together.
A hit.
All getting right. couples together.
Well, before the end of the show, we're going to have more Tissue Time. Maybe with Michelle if she's listening today, or maybe with a new broad. That's what we do.
Oh,
maybe with a new broad.
New broad.
Thank you, Sharon.
All right, take it easy. Thanks a lot, guys.
All right. We're going to do this, and then when we come back, we're going to do something else. All right, we're back with the Opie and Anthony program on XM Satellite Radio. I'm just amazed how big that jacket is. I got a picture of myself in Patrice's jacket, and it's going to be online in a few minutes. And then we got a picture of Patrice wearing the same jacket. And
you look warm and comfy.
You can see that it fits perfectly on you, and it's like a dress on me. It's unbelievable. And like I was saying, going to the bathroom, I wouldn't consider you a fat guy, just a really big guy.
I'm like big. I'm naked. I mean, you're what, naked. Like, I'm, if you saw me naked, it's like I'm fat naked, but in clothes and stuff, I'm a big dude.
How tall are you? 6'5"?
6'4".
6'4". Yeah. My God, man. Anyway, it made everyone laugh around here. The picture will be up in a few minutes. All right, you guys want to do the most annoying songs ever?
Yes.
We're going to do it anyway.
We're sacrificing the bear story for it.
Oh, all right, we can do that first. Well, the bear thing is just one of the big stories here in the New York area. They're doing a bear hunt in Jersey.
Jersey?
But it's not really hunting. And look, I'm not an animal rights guy at all. But, I mean, there's real hunters around America that are doing the real hunt. They're going out there. They're a little scared, and they're sitting and waiting.
A little scared?
Some of these guys are, sure. You're walking around the thick woods, you don't know what's going to jump out at you.
Right.
And this bear hunt in Jersey, oh my God, all of a sudden they let these people go, and the bears are just sleeping in trees. They can only hunt in an area that's like the size of a football field. It's unbelievable.
What's a dead bear? Besides a dead bear body, a dead bear get you? Like, because they're doing this because they need like 500 bears killed.
Oh, you get better boners.
Oh, bear claw stew or something?
Yeah,
like that.
Yeah, you got to, like, I don't know, throw it in your stew.
Bear meat, and they use the skins, you know.
People but, eat bear meat?
Yeah.
Do they really?
Yeah, people.
Well, there's a lot of controversy here in we're not in Jersey, but in Jersey there's a lot of controversy because you got the animal rights activists pissed off. You got the hunters that feel that, you know, this is their duty and their right, and the bear population, and is getting out of control some
Yeah,
say.
So there's a limited number that
people
they have
are
to go
saying,
out and
you know what? People,
shoot.
People, mm-hmm. population is getting out of control.
I
yeah,
know.
How about culling
well, we
that?
We ignore that, right. Could you imagine if they declared
can I sleep
hunting
a,
season
can I
on humans?
A sleeping motherfucker
like
that I
fucking
don't
want. Detroit's getting a little overpopulated, so we're going to allow a hunt for a certain amount of time.
too many Incas.
Incas.
You know what? The Incan population is...
How great of a world would it be if you're allowed to hunt humans for like 2 days?
We just decide somebody's some creature who only has sex... For natural sex. It's not like, oh, man, I need some pussy. They have sex for the natural reason to have
procreate.
Sex. To procreate. And there's a overblown population of animals that are just being animals.
Right.
But we, who just have babies and do things that we do, there's no human hunt.
Completely taking over the world, but we're just ignoring that
it's
fact.
It's because the houses are being built.
Right. Into
on
their
the
territory.
Place that they
in
used
the,
to fuck.
In the bear's territory.
And there was plenty of room for that.
Can you believe these people?
20 years ago, there was no problem because we weren't building there. So they were living their happy little bear life.
Oh, they had it.
They had a shitload of woods to run around
what
in.
What the fuck? There's a shark hunt today because, you know, people are getting killed on the here, but that's where the sharks live. They're doing what they're supposed to do. Yeah. We're not doing what we're supposed to do. It really makes me mad to just go, the bear population is overcrowded. Let's just go kill some bears. You cocksuckers. Excuse my, it's just, how dare you? That's why God is blowing everybody away and shaking everybody to death. And
is God angry at that?
Because it's like, it's arrogance, man. It's arrogance.
Again, I gotta put us, I agree, it is a little arrogant.
It's arrogance,
and
man.
And it's, I don't like seeing any little furry creature being killed.
Being shot.
Unless they're completely delicious, then I have no problem. But I'd rather
grizzlies.
Someone else do
they're
it.
Not the kind that knocks your face off with the, it's like,
the little black bears are fun.
It's
they're
the kind
cuddly.
That you can feed, and it goes, and you go, no, and you rub its head.
Do you think if there were panda bears that we'd be shooting them? Do you think if there were an overabundance of panda bears with those little white rings around their eyes?
Yeah. Even better, koala bears.
Koala bears, an overabundance of things. That poor little Qantas bear with the nose. And
all
he's
slow. And
slowly moving
just,
down.
Just eating their little leaves.
Eucalyptus. Anybody got any eucalyptus?
I want this.
There's some eucalyptus here, mate.
Yeah.
Hey, well,
yeah, you think they're just blowing them away? No way.
That's just wrong to me, man. I'm a lot of
controversy in Jersey, that's for sure. Well, the bear stories...
But we do have, and here it is, this won't end until something else comes to this planet and we are number two.
Aliens.
Right now, we're
aliens.
Number one. We are on top of the fucking food chain, number one as far as our divine spark and our fucking, we conquer the world, we rule.
But we're not number one on the chain.
No,
we're only
we are.
Number one on the chain from one simple aspect. We knew how to create weapons.
Right.
We knew how to think.
We take shit. Look around. Anywhere you are right now, out there, look at everything that is as buildings, cars, airplanes that fucking fly, flying machines. Look at everything. Everything you're looking at came from the fucking ground. We figured out a way to pull dirt out of the ground, find little pieces of it, trade them, melt it, cook it, fucking change it, and turn it into flying machines.
Into metal.
That's top of the fucking food chain.
It's top of the ingenuity chain.
It certainly
listen,
is.
Let me tell you what'll stop all that shit. Nature. And I'm gonna tell you, these bears are nature. When you get if bears even thought for 2 seconds, hold up, freeze. You know what? Four of us can kill that fat bastard.
Absolutely.
In locusts, there's 10 billion locusts. If they decided, you know what? Let's just start biting motherfuckers. We're finished. And I can't wait. I don't want to die being eaten by locusts.
No, who
but
does?
But I want everybody else to be dead eaten by. I want nature to come
but
back.
But the problem is they just can't organize. That's their problem.
They're not organized.
One guy's got the idea, but
they need
can't
a
talk
strong locust leader.
Strong locust. One locust just to hold up. 18 fists.
The motherfucking Martin Luther Locust.
I have a dream.
Martin Locust King.
Martin Locust King.
Follow me, you bastard.
I'm telling you, man. I'm fed up with these.
I will show you to the promised land.
Martin Locust.
Right through this motherfucker's belly. Just eat him.
Let's eat this motherfucker. Let's eat him.
Hey, we got guys that killed bear on the line today.
All right. The bear hunt.
The bear hunt. The scary bear hunt that's happening in Jersey. Mike, what's up?
Hey, how you doing, Hope? How you doing, Anthony?
Hey, man.
What's happening?
Oh, you bear hunter. I would have liked you, but you're shooting bears.
Nah, you know what it is? It's these activists. They go and they build these brand-new, big, multi-million-dollar homes up in Sussex County, New Jersey, and they're the ones that are against this. They're the ones taking their property away. The bears got nowhere to go, and as human, we're the head of the food chain. Everybody knows that. And as the population of humans go up, the bears, they're going up too, and you know, one's got to kill the other.
Yeah, I mean, I agree. I mean, you know, we have no choice. We got to control the bear population because we've already decided that we want to live in these areas, and we're never going to live, you know, in harmony with the bear.
Should we have not moved in to those areas? Is that
you probably should have said, you know what?
But see, it's like this guy's saying what he's saying, which is understandable, right?
Mm-hmm.
But look at how we are. This is what I'm talking about, arrogance. We have no sense of fairness. If a bear killed somebody walking through the woods who didn't have a pistol, and a bear's like, wow, you know what? Right now, I feel overpopulated. I'm going to just chew that dude up and kill him.
Right.
It will be a hunt not because there's overpopulation of bears. It'll be a hunt because that bear killed that person.
Yeah.
Then it's going to be, it's different from...
Just a retribution hunt.
Yeah, it's not going to be rational.
The yep. bear aren't going after people that are in the woods. It's going after the people that are in the neighborhood.
In their houses. And,
in the backyard,
which is really funny.
In the backyard playing on the swings, and the bear's coming right into the backyard and mauling a kid.
You, they moved into where the bear lives.
That's right.
And with that's children. Right. And put up a swing set. It's like, so if the bear's walking, even out of his peripheral, is something moving? There's like a kid swinging.
Yeah.
Then they're going to have one of those stop motion, those what the cameras,
security
cameras with a bear like pulling some girl.
Big bear, just
with the stop motion security bear.
I put in for a permit. I got the permit, and I didn't have it all intentions on doing it. But when you got a 347-pound bear walk 10 feet in front of you and just stare you down, you got to do something.
Stare you down.
But they're black bears, man. They're black bears. They're not. Huh?
He was bigger than you.
But those bears that those guys are hunting in New Jersey, they're not dangerous bears. They're black bears.
No, because the one that I did shoot had two tags in his ears, and it was a nuisance bear. And if you listen, they already announced it on the
radio. It was the tags in his ears.
That sounds like slavery. They're going nuisance nigga right there.
Oh, it's the 60s all over again.
A nuisance bear.
Nigga, they ain't going
to get the fire hoses. That's a nuisance bear.
Ain't that the one? Didn't we tell you not to come around here, boy?
Oh.
That's that Rambo bear. Turn around.
This one has a nuisance tag and an uppity tag.
Uppity.
He got an uppity tag in his ear. He's going to have to hobble his.
This is the white woods. The bear woods is over there.
You're in the white woods.
a nuisance
tag.
Also, another guy that killed a bear yesterday. Jerry?
Hey, guys, how's it going?
Were you fearing for your life yesterday when you killed that bear?
It's coming right for us.
Well, I just wanted to, you know, add a little gas to the fire. On top of everything else, we're allowed to bait the bear.
Yeah, I heard about this practice with donuts and stuff.
So not only is there a bear hunt and there's a certain number of tags that get issued, and you have to call, like today, for instance, the hunters have to call up a number, and if there was enough bear killed, they call the hunt off.
Right.
Yeah, but what they allow you to do is, and I'm one of those people that moved into Sussex, built the house. We love it up there, and I'm also a hunter. And yesterday, I shot me a black bear, and but we actually bait the bear. I mean, it really is kind of we laugh at it. We put out jelly donuts and honey. Ugh.
And you can't. And it's one of those things that you can't. You have to continuously shoot a bear,
Jerry. Did you
until it dies?
And Jerry, be honest, man. Did you feel bad at all? On any level, after the lights went out and you're by yourself,
falling. If I didn't on this bear, my first bear I ever shot. If you've ever heard a bear cry,
ugh.
I will tell you right now.
This is what it sounds like when bears cry.
Ugh. It's a shriek that just goes right through you. It
shouldn't be called
really
a hunt if you're laying out jelly donuts.
Yeah, jelly donuts, the things they're eating.
Hey, look, it's a picnic basket.
Let me tell you something, man. You know how you said when aliens... When aliens come in, and we're... I can't wait till aliens come here, right? And they get ready to shoot somebody, and the person's going, please don't kill me. Please, I got a family. Please don't help me. Please don't kill me. And all the alien hears is... Oh, God. Did you hear that human cry? If you hear a human cry, that bear knows he's going
to
die.
You know what, though? You know what? Excuse me, sir. Hold on 2 seconds.
Bye.
You know what? I'd rather it be that the aliens come down and instead they're so far ahead of us that we don't even understand. Like the animals. The animal's just eating a jelly donut. He don't know he's going to be shot. He's sitting there. So, like, we could just be a family eating dinner and all of a sudden your head just disappears out of nowhere.
I don't want that to happen.
Just nothing.
I want motherfuckers to know. I just need people. This is so wrong to me, man. It's wrong.
So we're trying to plead with it.
Yeah,
like,
man.
Excuse me, I have a family.
Yeah.
A wife here. We I think we could get along as beings and share the planet. And he's just here. And they're sitting there going, oh, look at him. He's screaming. I felt bad on my first one. When I had to kill my first one.
Please don't kill me and my family. I can't wait.
All right, Jerry.
Yeah.
So it was exciting yesterday?
Yeah, that was exciting. Our group dropped $3. We got a bear. It was nice. But what's crazy is you put out 50-gallon drums,
And when you bait the drums, you bang the hell out of them, and you make as much noise as possible to also let everyone know out there, oh, they just put food in the barrel. So you put the food in, and then you bang the shit out of it, and it's like, you know, they almost come when they hear the
they
noise.
They know. It's like the feeding bell.
Oh, my God.
And they creep up. Yeah, that
is this
thing
over? How many bears do you cocksuckers have to kill, man? How many before it's over?
It's just about over, I think.
Yeah, I think they got 300.
You know, if you
what's
had
the limit? 400?
I think it's about 5 something this year, right?
Yeah.
And is he cooking? Are you cooking the bear?
Yeah, what are you doing with it?
Oh, guys, bear meat is brutal. It's like chewing on a Cooper tire. It's horrible.
So it's just a dead bear body somewhere now.
Let me tell you something. In Maine, we hunt bear, and you bait bear in Maine. Now, a lot of places you bait bear, or you tree them with dogs. Bear don't even eat bear.
Yeah, so you're just...
You could throw anything out for a bear, and they'll just devour it.
Yeah.
And you could take a cut-up bear that we just skinned, you know, took what we wanted, and throw it, and they won't even touch it.
Don't you get that animal he feels like it's cannibalism. He's like, hey, I'm not going to eat my own kind. Doesn't that give you the sense that it can't communicate on that high level, but it's something that it won't eat its own kind.
Hey, Patrice, I want to know when the aliens come, guys. Yeah. What are they gonna bait us with? What do you think? Pussy, beer.
Same thing, dogs? Jelly donuts. It'll fucking work, right?
Who is that private pile?
Sir, jelly donuts, sir.
And I'm not too worried with the alien thing because I think they're gonna go after the my black brothers first anyway.
No, because we're the ones. They know white people are fucking up the earth. They're gonna get you first, and they know it's over after you're dead.
And that's nothing. You shoot fucking a black bear, a deer. It doesn't matter. We're all the same to them.
Well, let's go to the tape here. We got the news talking about the bear hunt in Jersey today.
Despite vocal protests, New Jersey's bear hunt got underway today in freezing temperatures. State officials say at least 54 bears were killed. CBS2's Jay Dow has
bear
more.
Holocaust.
Nick Diamandis Jr. is no mere observer.
I took the shot.
He's an experienced bear hunter, all of 11 years old,
11.
Who with his 12-gauge shotgun took down this 200-plus pound bear today, not far from his home in Oak Ridge.
Sure enough, he died right down on the bottom of the hill.
Nick and his father joined almost 4,500 other hunters in the northwestern corner of New Jersey for day one of a week-long bear hunt, the second since 2003, when hunters killed 328 bears.
We structured the hunt at this time of year so that some bears, particularly the females that are pregnant, will be in their dens so that we don't get into a situation where we're potentially taking too many bears too quickly.
Yeah, just the males.
You hear that, Patrice? An 11-year-old.
11 years old, he's shooting. That's nice.
We're so fucked as a society,
man. Yeah, it's
man.
Just wrong, man. It's just
I'm not going to lie to you. I don't get this at all on any level.
I like shooting. I don't like hunting.
Nature's been taking care of itself way before we got here, but now we have decided we have to take care of nature.
It's very cruel, man. It's very because they do what they do, man. It is what it is. You know what I mean? Mm.
I just don't get it. You know what I mean? I'm sure a lot of people...
Too many bears, let's kill them. It's like, why don't you find the most promiscuous male bear and maybe neuter them? Do that. Maybe there's got to be a black bear that's fucking all the black bear
all
bitches.
All the other ones just...
And just neuter that
cut
dude.
Cut his balls off.
Do something like that.
Go hunt some Iraqis.
You know what?
If you want a real fight, you know, instead of baiting him with jelly donuts, try to bait an Iraqi with a jelly donut.
Grizzly bears with nothing but a loincloth and a Bowie knife. Now that's a hunt.
There you
that's
go.
Where,
yeah, they should have some special rules. That's
yeah,
right.
Yeah.
And that's where all the AIDS and shit come from. Is
what?
The, is
hunting
the,
bears?
No, is the rainforest from development and people going and spreading out into places where we should not be.
You are insane.
All right. AIDS is from the
rainforest.
Yes.
AIDS is from the green monkey.
No, man.
Someone fucked
the
green monkey in Africa.
Africa.
They trace that
Africa.
Shit right back to Africa.
Blame niggas for everything.
Their fucking biggest export is disease, Africa.
It's those creepy, spooky jungles that we go in. We're expanding into places where we shouldn't
South America.
Yes,
the rainforest.
down there by the...
Yeah, man, hey. All of that stuff, man, going on over there.
Let's go to another clip here.
Protesters, who took to the woods in an obvious attempt to distract the hunters and rescue injured bears, say none should be taken at all.
Within minutes, they can be aroused and disturbed and moved off.
This is totally a trophy hunt. It's about killing cubs and sticking their heads on the wall.
Some hunters dispute that assertion. Others do not.
And this bear season is very, very necessary, just from the aspect of children and livestock.
What do you plan to do with this bear?
This bear, well, we'll eat him and probably do a full body mount since it's a, you know, it's a nice bear for him.
There you go. Take him to the taxidermist.
Do you see the people who called the show to say they shot him, but then listen to the guys who are the representatives, like, to make it so civilized. But the guys are like, hey, we fucking bang the heap a dooba dabba. And then this guy's like, yeah, we eat them, and it's necessary that we do what we do. And, you know, murders,
we must do
what we do.
I got no problem with the bear hunt. I don't care.
I do.
I think it's a little weird. I don't, the baiting thing isn't really skillful hunting. I'm sorry. It's just not. But the other kind of hunting, I have no problem with hunting. For me, it doesn't work. I always... Even, like, out in California when I used to shoot rabbits.
Jesus, man.
I shoot, like, a rabbit.
And you have such beautiful bunny eyes. How can you do that?
Well, because I'd eat the rabbit. I was out.
Tastes like chicken.
I was out camping.
I'm not as bothered with bears. Mm. I don't want to see it, but it doesn't make me trip out to think about guys shooting bears, I guess, if there's an old popular. But it's just, if I saw it, it would kill me, you know?
Yeah, I don't know. I want to watch.
I don't want to see
like,
it.
Like, I love steak. I love chicken. I don't want to see them snapping necks or shooting bolts through their head to, you know, get the meat. But keep that assembly line of death going. Because I love the burger.
I love meat. I like my food freshly murdered for me.
That fucking cow holocaust that is going on. Do you understand how many fucking cows have to be pulverized on a daily basis to feed this country? It's astronomical, the number of fucking cows.
You know what I bought from the butcher yesterday? Huh? I bought 3 shell steaks, 2 T-bones.
They're beautiful.
See, then you can't say shit.
Patrice, you ever take
murdered food, and I probably bought some bear meat once too.
You ever barbecue?
I had a baby seal sandwich and didn't know it.
A baby seal sandwich.
Man, give me a medium baby seal. Motherfucker, this shit is overcooked. Yeah, see, send it back.
See, I want to know. None of us can talk when it comes down to it. If you want to protect nature.
You ever have a London broil?
I'm a big
just look in your shopping cart.
Barbecued London broil, just marinated and thinly sliced. I don't care if they're fucking killing, which they are, just millions of cows. Millions.
Yeah, we should get
cows.
A number. Let's get a number.
Get
someone,
a number.
Someone do the
I
want
to know how many cows
a day have to die.
A day have to die for our meat.
I guess it's the suffering that I that
is it the suffering?
With. It's because the, if even if baby seals were say gassed. So that people can have their little baby seal
their
coat.
Pelts,
I
so
might
soft.
Not be as bad on it, but the way they
the
do it,
clubbing.
The
yeah.
suffering.
Yeah.
The like pigs, if you see a pig, abattoir, the damn pig slaughterhouse,
yeah.
those pigs go in alive and come out dead in 5 seconds. They just go and come out freshly
pork chopped.
They don't know what happened. There's no like squirming around and dying. It's just like, oh, you a dead motherfucker. But certain, the suffering is what, that's why I don't eat veal. Not because it's not delicious, because I saw how they make veal.
Where does that veal want to go anyway? What does that veal really want to do?
The suffering that it does so I can have a delicious veal chop is too much for me.
The chickens
I've chosen
are suffering too,
a veal lifestyle.
All their heads are put out of a little hole,
but
and then here comes something that whops their head off. Once your head is gone, it's a wrap.
It's over, Johnny. They're done.
One more clip here. We got to try to move on. We got the Tourette's comic that's jonesing to get in here. Or he's just having Tourette's.
Oh,
the state is hoping to cull the 2,000 to 3,000 estimated bears in New Jersey that increasingly interact with humans, mostly because of easy access to human garbage. But witness this wounded bear from the first hunt 2 years ago. Bear advocates spread out into the woods today looking for more and risking violation of the state's hunter harassment law.
Not in the best interest of the person who is concerned about bears to get into a situation like that. That's an unsafe situation, and obviously we don't want to encourage that.
Now, these hunts permits are not automatic. The state says it'll be reviewing them every year. However, Governor-elect Corzine in the campaign expressed his opposition to a bear hunt.
He opposed the bear hunt.
There's a hunter's harassment law?
Yeah, because you can't go out there and because it's probably dangerous for a protester to be marching around the woods, you know. I'm sure they have all kinds of gimmicks dressed in a bear suit as to trying to be a martyr.
You're a bear killer! And then the person looks around twice.
No, but it's a hunter's harassment law. Protecting the hunter even more.
Yeah,
even though he's well protected with the gun that he's got.
It's to protect the hunter from
You're
those stupid protesters.
You're an asshole killing these bears! Stop it! You know,
Uh-oh. We have a 1998, I guess, is the most. But I guess beef consumption hasn't really gone up that much or down that much in that long. Here's the number I have. How many cows do you believe were killed in 1998?
1998?
In the year of 1998, how many cows killed for beef for this country?
200, 300, 400 million people in this country. Probably half eat meat, half eat cows, half eat steak.
I'll go with 200 million.
200 million cows?
Mm-hmm.
I go with 30 million cows.
Is this just for America or the world?
That's America, I guess. Okay. Yeah.
30 million cows. Okay.
So 41,300,000 cows. You had like a cow per friggin'
per person. Yeah.
Well, yeah.
What a steak.
A lot of people
like
meat
different
out there.
Ground meat. And
that's what I'm saying. You can't eat a cow a year? One
a
person?
Year?
And a lot of people only eat steak. Like,
would you?
Think about it.
I mean, I think I had almost a whole cow this week.
Yeah. Well, you got to think, you know, there's Patrice and then there's vegans.
There's Patrice.
Then there's vegans.
And then there's everybody else.
listen,
we got to. Should we take another break? We'll play Gangsta Fag. We'll get the Tourette's dude in. And I don't know if we're going to get to the annoying songs. We'll try, though. Oh, Jägermeister music tour is happening, Anthony, with
yes,
Disturbed and special guest Corrosion of Conformity. Love Jägermeister. And they're giving out a lot of prizes, including, I don't know, prizes from Schecter, Coffin Case, and Peavey. Get tickets now to see Corrosion of Conformity and Disturbed at Ticketmaster outlets or online at Ticketmaster.com. For more tour information, visit JägermeisterTour.com or www.disturbed1.com. Brought to you by Jägermeister Liqueur, 35% alcohol by volume. Must be at least 21 to receive prizes. Prizes were permitted by law. Now, here's the deal. JägermeisterTour.com, I said that.
Music Tour.
Oh, I mess that up every time, too. JägermeisterMusicTour.com, I'm sorry. And if you're in Portland, Maine, or in the surrounding area, and you want to see Disturbed at the State Theater tonight, call in to win a pair of VIP tickets, where you will go to the show and meet Disturbed and Corrosion of Conformity, all right?
Is this a true stat?
What happened?
Getting another statistic here. The total number of mammals and birds raised and killed for food in the U.S. this year is expected to reach 9.9 billion
That's chicken.
Animals. That's chicken, pigs,
cows,
turkeys, whatever other animals
what
we eat.
What else do we eat?
What else
Fish?
Do we eat?
Fish,
that would have to be huge. It's just said mammals and birds.
Oh, it didn't even say
fish.
Fish
aren't even considered. No one gets pissed about
dolphins.
The fish.
Dolphins.
There are people that call themselves vegetarians and eat fucking fish.
Well, you know why fish is one of those
animal rights activists coming out for the fucking fish.
I used to do a bit about this shit, so I mean, don't say I'm a hack if you heard it.
No.
But it's like, I'm glad that my food comes murdered for me. But it's like, if I had to kill my own food, I would be a vegetarian, except for fish. Because they don't have, they're built for murder. Because they don't have any eyebrows. Like, and they don't have any ouch. Like, they don't scream.
No.
It's just, like, so it's like if a guy who couldn't blink, right, you was punching him and stabbing him, and he just kept looking at you with his eyes and not doing anything, but just, and he was suffocating because he couldn't breathe. And you just keep stabbing him just because he's looking at you. So fish are set up to die. So in the least,
that is true.
We're supposed to eat fish.
Holy shit. It would be a different story if a fish could frown.
If a fish could go, oh, yeah. Man, that hurts. You'd be like, I'm sorry.
Like he's got the hook in his mouth, and his eyes, his little eyebrows are going down in the back like, ow.
He had fish eyebrows.
And
like,
he's going,
If he can at least squint.
Oh, you'd never hook him. Imagine that. And why don't we, and that's probably the reason we don't hunt any other land animal with a hook and bait.
Because how evil would that be to hook him and just watch him going, oh, I'm trying to reel in a cow.
Oh, suffering the whole way.
And they make noises. Fish are just born to die.
Fish, a fish will make the same look eating and being happy, I guess, as a fish could be, as it makes when you pull it into the boat and hit it with a wrench.
Exact pain
it's
and suffering.
It's the same face.
As soon as you pull out the water, it's choking to death. But the eyes are just, the eyes are like, hey, what's happening, baby?
So you don't cry,
no lashes,
no lids, no nothing.
No eyelashes.
Open fucking eyes.
God didn't give fish eyebrows.
Doesn't even squint a little for a wince.
What if the fish cried air bubbles? Different story?
They do. They're suffocating.
You don't see that shit on the boat.
Yeah,
you're crying somewhere inside that fish body of theirs.
The way they die, they just die.
Once you bring them on the boat, you're doing them a
no
favor.
No suffering
to kill
with fish.
He's suffocating.
All right, get us out of here. We got to move the show. You ready to go, bro? He's ready. Okay, we'll get the Tourette's comic on the air next.
It came from a real place when I said it, you cocksucker.
We never stopped over here. Land of Confusion from Disturbed.
Oh, man.
It's the ONA virus spreading across America. Tissue Time might have to wait. We might have to do Tissue Time. How about this? Ladies, we're looking for more females to have phone sex with our listeners. Strangers.
Yeah, of course.
You're good at phone sex. You're a female. Want to turn on a bunch of guys all over America. I want to do Tissue Time to start the show tomorrow.
So we'll just start it.
We'll put the word out right now. Tomorrow's show, we'll start with Tissue Time, okay?
Ooh.
And we're not even going to remember because we have short-term memory
we're
problems.
We're retarded.
So all of a sudden, we're going to start the show tomorrow. The phones are going to be lit with hot girls with sexy voices that want to do Tissue Time. We're going to go, what the? What? And then, bam, the show's going to be off to a great start tomorrow.
I won't remember, so don't.
I'm not going to remember, so remind us. Tissue Time starts off tomorrow's show, okay?
I'm like that guy from Memento. That's me. I forget it in seconds.
What are you talking about?
I'm like that guy from Memento.
All right, what's this comic's name?
I woke up this morning. Tomorrow, you'll get nothing out of me because I won't remember. But I wake up this morning. The worst thing, it was 4:50.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I get up usually a quarter after 5. 4:50, I had to piss so bad. You can't get up, take a leak, and come back to bed when the alarm's going off at 5:15.
Yes, you can.
No, you can't.
Very low
worst
lighting.
Worst time.
Don't open your eyes all
no,
the way.
No, because now I'm laying there going, it's 4:50. I'm just going to try to go back to sleep even though I got to take a leak. And then it gets worse, and you're like, I'm not getting back to sleep. And then you look. Now it's 5. You get up and take a leak. The second you lay down, you got to get back up. And then there's the hassle of actually getting back up in the upright position from laying down. So, I was up this morning now from...
For 20 lousy minutes. Who cares?
It's a big 20 minutes at that hour. That's a very important point. That's not like fucking, 10 o'clock and 10:20 in the morning.
Yeah.
Or fucking, 8 p.m. and 8:20. That's fucking between an hour that starts 4 in the morning. Even though it's 4:50, my clock's still out of 4 and a 5.
Yep.
That's the difference between last night and this morning.
It really is. It's the same thing as when you walk up some stairs and then you see there's an escalator. And you just go, oh, man. But it's like, what? You're up the stairs, but like, no, motherfucker, there was an escalator.
Now I'm going to be tired later.
Yeah, like, it's like, oh, man, I didn't have to get up till 4:20.
I could have saved a little energy.
But it's 4:07. No. You got to understand.
Big difference.
It is a mental thing. You're right.
It is.
All right, let's get Lewis in here. Lewis is a comic with Tourette's. We want to get the rest of the gang in here. We set up a microphone for him and everything. He's going to do a little stand-up. We want to do this bit where we do open mic one morning.
Yeah. I'm just going to reference this.
Huh? Wait, get on mic, bro.
Okay. Right.
What do you got?
It's a book.
You got a book?
It's my children's book I just came out with.
Oh, that's right. You were telling us that you have a children's book.
Yeah.
Little Twitching Timmy the Turtle with Tourette's.
Aww.
Holy crap. What page is good to read real fast?
The bio page.
The bio page?
The bio page.
Where's the bio page?
It's in the back.
Why is that a good page to read?
Because it's about me.
You got any other
copies? No, we'll talk to you. Here. We'll talk to you.
Let's see.
We don't have to read about
it. It's a cute kid's book, It explains what Tourette's is and,
You
know.
You illustrated it, too?
What kind of Tourette's do you have?
Well, you know what? There's not really like class A, class B types of Tourette's. Like there isn't a diabetes. Mine, I was diagnosed when I was 7, so it's just, you know, I can have, you know, be flipping out, cursing, doing one moment, and then the next it can be so subtle that you wouldn't know I have it.
You got the cursing too? Yeah.
I do that occasionally. I more have the like the the gruntal tics and like the, you know, facial twitching and all that stuff, and you know it's tough. But what the fuck, I gotta live with
it. So what do you say? What do you say before this? Before you learn swears at 7, what are you saying at 7 during a Tourette's? You know what I'm saying?
Well, when I was 7 years old, my parents had noticed that I was making the vocal tics first. That was the first thing. I didn't do the cursing.
Oh, they do smacking the head. Knock it off! Fucking look like a retard. Knock it off.
Well, that was the cure for everything back then.
Parents, yeah.
Sometimes it worked, and sometimes it didn't.
And he has steaming confidence for a Tourette's guy.
Hell yeah, he does. Yeah.
He's one. He really is an air finger gun guy.
Thank God, because I hate when people come in and you're not supposed to acknowledge it.
Yeah, and it's like, all right, everyone's looking at each other like, what the fuck is he doing?
Well, growing up, I always tried to hide it, but you know, eventually, that you know, I was like, you know, screw this. I have this. You know, I'm gonna fucking deal with it. Now I'm 20 years old now, and I'm still living with this. And
you got a girlfriend?
Hell. Well, my sex life is good, but I don't have a girlfriend right now.
How was your sex life? Pussy. Good?
I'm like a lady's personal vibrator, you know, especially when my mouth ticks are acting.
Oh, he just has to tick a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but that's back end. What's the front end? What's the game? What's your game?
You know what? I don't really
What's
like
your game when a girl looks at you and goes,
okay,
you know, all right. Half of your face is down low and you're swearing at me, hello.
You know, I really don't talk about this, but to be honest with you, when, you know, I meet a chick, I just got to have confidence, and my Tourette's are bound to happen, so I play it up when it does, and usually I go for the sympathy angle, and it usually works pretty good.
What does
know?
Tourette's mean? Like, where did they get that word?
To be honest with you, I don't know the definition, but it derived from the name of whoever discovered it.
Oh. There's a guy, Tourette?
Something like that.
I thought it was from the gun, from the rapid fire swearing. Shit.
By the way, no one's ever shooting this guy.
Oh yeah, that's
I'm
a rough target, man.
That's
a rough target.
No, well, I was thinking more. This guy has all the expressions, man. He's no fish.
Yeah. Oh yeah, the eyebrows are gone.
It's funny because
I know his face is everywhere.
That's why women love me to go down on him. It's awesome. But you know, there's different types.
I'm
of
a thinking man.
Yeah, Joe different ticks.
Yeah, well, that's what we call them ticks. Like ticks. That's a classification of what they are. Like I have this one tick where I can be waving my hand up and down constantly in the air. I can't even go to fucking auctions anymore because of it. You know?
Oh, there we go. All right, there's a joke.
Nah, he's hilarious. He's fucking.
Because who the hell does go to auctions?
The disabled made it funny. There you go.
But that's just, I'm saying, when you go to get some ass, man, that 5 or 10 minutes that you have to, like, get a girl hooked into you, man.
Yeah.
And you start doing this. It's like, Tourette's is one of those diseases that you don't believe someone has.
Exactly.
Like, when you're talking to a girl, you're like, that fuck face! And she's like, what? It's like, hey, baby, I got Tourette's. Well, yeah, right, Mr.
Bullshit.
Sarcasm.
Well, people say it to me all the time. They're like, you have Tourette's. Prove it. Do some Tourette. That's what I hear all the fucking time.
Do some Tourette.
It's like me going, exactly. It's like me going up to a model saying, if you're a model, then prove it. Eat something and throw it up.
Right,
it's
right.
Not something that I can actually, you know, just do on a drop of the dime. I never know when it's going to happen.
That was a good one.
Now, does talking fast, is there techniques that help you through it?
Well, you know what? I'm promoting a children's book, so I won't talk about some of them. But for the most part, nicotine in cigarettes, they've done some studies that actually temporarily calms it down. Now, they're not going to give cigarettes to 12-year-olds.
I'm not talking about addictive fucking drug. I'm talking about mental things that you do to stop yourself from doing what you...
Well,
like, it looked like, now you see how you're listening?
Yeah.
That's so when
like,
the twitching starts,
like, when
baby.
You talk about it a lot, like, the HBO just did this documentary on kids with Tourette's, and while watching it, you know, it brought me back to my childhood. I'm sitting here with the popcorn's flying everywhere, because I'm twitching like a fucking nutcase, because when I think about it, it's like, it's psychological, and I can't help it. I know it's going to happen. I have this one tick where I'm fucking jumping up and down like this, and I'm in Wawa, they're Wawa's in Jersey, like, and I'm getting a pack of cigarettes, and I'm jumping up and down, and it's like, I can't help it. I have to live with this. And, you know,
see, right now you seem very normal. When we were waiting for you to come in, man, you were all over the place.
Well, because,
but now that you're talking in front of a microphone,
he's talking.
And
keeps him, but you
and
see
he's very animated.
If he listens, he can put that energy into his talking, but when he's just like kind of, you know, no black man can have Tourette's, he'd be dead. If my nigga walks in the 7-Eleven going, jumping around, cigarettes, shoot this motherfucker.
He's up to no good, obviously.
He's obviously on the crack pipe.
Nigga jumping around, clicking.
Dude, just stand there a minute.
Yeah, stand there.
Just stand there.
He can't.
Don't talk. Don't move. Let's just
stand there. Let's see if you can make 30 seconds without saying
anything. Yeah, you can't. He fucking
or just
can't.
Concentrate.
There it is.
Mm-hmm. Look at him.
Now, can't you just,
wait,
like...
Oh.
No.
God,
wow, that was rough.
You have an itch somewhere, and you really have...
Ovi, you got it. Here's his thing. As a comic, he's a comic. Yeah. Here's what he should do.
Yeah.
You should dress up in a suit so that you can pretend that you're fixing your tie.
Yeah.
If you like, as you...
All the time.
And you could just always be just going, I tell you, it's crazy. Yeah. It's crazy in here, I tell you.
I always have ways of hiding it, like...
That built up like...
Yeah, that was too good. We got to do that again. Let's see how long it can last.
Well, imagine when I went from growing up in school. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
I'll take a bet.
Right.
I got $10.
He cannot go.
He can't go 30 seconds.
I'll give you less.
30.
He can't go 15 seconds without...
I'm going 10.
And it has to be a sound, not just a twitch.
All right. A sound. I'm saying 10.
You say 10, I say 15.
But keep in mind, we're talking about it so much. That's what's why.
All right, guys. All right,
get ready.
That's what I'm banking on.
Here we go.
Give him a chance.
All right, on the 10. Here we go.
10 seconds.
Lewis, go.
And go.
Mm-hmm. He's concentrating, man. He's concentrating. It's 7 seconds right now.
Damn it.
10 seconds is up.
I'm out.
Very good. He's up.
Damn it.
14 seconds.
Damn it. Patrice just got in.
You know, I just had a picture of him in the back of my mind saying, if you're not going to fucking switch, I'll bust a cap in your ass.
Wait a minute. I got $10 for this motherfucker.
Let's go double or nothing, man.
Double or nothing.
There you go. Give that man that money right there, man. Take that money right there.
God damn.
And you can imagine, you guys are having a fucking great time. That's what I went through in high school.
How did you sit in class?
That's some nerve-wracking.
I had this one, you know.
Nerve-wracking, man.
You're telling me. I was in history class this one time, and the history teacher was writing notes on the board, and he had just made fun of my friend. You know, they try to pick out a student if they're not listening and try to embarrass them. So this is the only time I really did it on purpose. And I was trying to get back at the teacher for fucking with my friend. So he's in the middle of writing notes, and he's looking back to see if everyone's paying attention, and I start doing my flipper with emphysema tick, which is a real one. It's like, so I'm doing this the whole time, and you know, you gotta have fun with it because
how can you mock your own tick? That means, like, that means you should be able to control it.
But you know what? First of all, I'm an actor. I've only been doing stand-up for about a year. I've been acting.
You're an actor.
I've been acting for 12 years, and whenever I'm on set or doing a stage or doing stage work or a film or whatever, it seems like I can shelf it while I'm concentrating on what it is. Like in that same documentary HBO did, they had this one kid. He's a little 12-year-old. He's like screaming the weirdest things you can think of, and one of them is caffeine, caffeine, and he's just screaming this, and he plays the drums, and whenever he plays the drums, it like goes away, you know.
Hey, do you have the racist Tourette's?
Because
that would be so huge today, man.
is there such thing as racist Tourette's?
Well, I had a lot of black friends growing up, so like they would, and this is funny that you say that, because they would always try to make me do it. They would be like, yo, you know, you gotta shout the N-word, and I just feel really uncomfortable doing that. But they talked about it so much because they knew when I think about something, a word, if you keep saying the word around me, eventually it can become a tick.
Man. Oh, boy.
So every
Come
day
on, like
they
parrot.
Would be like this, what's up, nigga? How you doing, nigga? Nigga, 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 and it just clicked in my head, and I was like, guys, stop doing this, because I know you want me to say this, and basically...
Stop it! Stop, you're going to force me to be racist!
I know!
Then he said something else, they kept that nigga, he goes, porch monkey! Whoa. We didn't say porch monkey, motherfucker!
Saying that
shit. He was your inspiration, now, nigga! Cone! Huh? What?
These are the type of guys I grew up with every single day. I love it, that's why I make fun.
Oh, look, it's Bill Burr in Charleston, South Carolina on CNN. He dyed his hair black.
I wonder where he's been. All right, well, how about another bet? This is too good.
Double or nothing.
Well, the listeners want to bet. They're betting at home.
All right, look.
They're playing the whole 15
seconds is it, man.
He cannot.
I think the pressure's on. Even though I lost with 10 seconds before, I'm going with 10 again.
You're going with 10?
I'm going with 10. I should get odds.
It's a shame you can't smoke in here. That would buy me about 20 seconds.
I'm going with 18. Because he's going to fight through 15, but he can't go past 15.
All right. How much? 10 bucks?
10 bucks.
All right. They're betting at home, too, man. The answer feedback's going crazy. Some people saying best bet ever.
Shit! We got 12 seconds!
Wait, we didn't even start yet!
We didn't start yet!
All right, here we go.
We didn't start yet.
I got 10. All right, what's the bet? We got money on the
table. I got 10 bucks.
All right, 10 bucks is 10 what?
Bucks on...
He says 10.
I say 18. Says, I'm giving him 3 more seconds.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You can tell I have a lot of dignity.
I say 10.
Are we doing prices right rules or just closest?
No, it's...
Ant says 10. Patrice says 18, right?
I haven't been this nervous since I was on The Tonight Show, and I was going nuts even when I was there with my ticks in the dressing room.
You were on The Tonight Show?
Yeah, I did. I did one of those segments that, you know how David Letterman has stupid human tricks? Well, he has, like, don't try this at home. And it's not my it's actually links back to my Tourette's. Because I was on this Tourette medicine, it made me gain a lot of weight when I was growing up. I peaked at 300 pounds at 16.
Get the fuck out of here.
And I lost over 85 pounds, and I ended up having all this loose skin. So long story short, I do this trick where I can stick a wiffle ball bat. Uh-oh. Underneath my loose belly skin and hit a wiffle ball off a t-ball stand without using my hands. And I hit it to Leno on set, and that was the gig
that was
I did.
Thing. Do you still have the loose skin?
Unfortunately, I'm trying to get rid of it. Do you want to see it?
Yeah. Wait, how much do you weigh right now?
Right now I weigh about... See, originally I was 85, but I gained a few back, so I'm about 230, 235.
He doesn't look 230. 230.
Well, I have about 30 pounds of skin.
Oh, that's why. Because
doesn't look 230.
Oh, wow. Get that on video.
Shit. You know, and it's sad because I don't have any insurance, so it's not like I can get the surgery.
Why did the guy do this to him? He's built like
I know.
A
it's
bitch
like, what the fuck? He already made me have fucking Tourette's, and now he has me have titties.
He has Tourette's, and he's built like a
marshmallow.
A mother. He's built like a mother.
I'm built like a 90-year-old hooker.
A bitch with a newborn.
He's built like a 52-year-old mom with 5
mom.
kids.
I can't believe he has lasagna and Tourette's. Only The Rock should have Tourette's. Like, he should pull up his shirt and go, I am as sexy as
Jesus,
you can be. I work out every fucking day.
Where's a pizza maker when you need one?
He's a lazy Tourette's. All that shake is to have you lose at least 10 pounds a week, motherfucker.
All right.
What is he eating?
It was funny because I was sitting down on my couch.
Right now, though, that 18 right. is not good, but I'm going to stick with 18.
Yeah. All right.
We're going to bet again. Here we go. I'm Mike.
What are you going with? I'm just like the MC here.
Anybody
else in?
I'm the game show host.
Come on, anybody else in, dude?
Anybody else want to do a little side bet?
Who's in, though? What are you in for?
What are you in for? This is some good money going back and forth.
Give me 2-1 on like 30 seconds.
2-1 on 30? He ain't lasting 30 seconds.
He ain't going 30 seconds.
Another thing. Reading helps me sometimes diverse it. So you don't want me to do anything.
No. We just want you to
concentrate your best.
Just stand.
There is so much betting going on around the world right now. The feedback is going nuts.
And to think I wrote the short bus for 3 years for nothing. This paid off.
All right, here we go. On my cue. All right, you can do whatever you want until I say go.
All right.
2-1, go.
Can I talk?
Uh-oh, no.
All right, start again.
He can't talk.
You can't talk. You gotta just be completely quiet.
On my cue, we're gonna start. You can't say shit. It's gonna be silence. Go.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I don't like what you're doing. Opie, you're counting and giving him something to concentrate on.
I don't want to know.
Anthony, look.
Anthony,
you know that playing around. around.
Anthony's a professional.
Know that this is not fixed. I'm going to start right now.
No, don't tell me
when you're starting the timing.
No. All right. That's right.
I just think this should be complete silence.
You're right.
You're giving him something to work on.
Nothing.
That was a good one. Is that called the chainsaw? You seem to name them.
That's called
rubber lifts.
That's the workout after stretch.
All right, bed is back on. I'm sorry, Anthony. I just thought it would be. I don't know what would happen to the system if it's just dead air for a while. We should be all right.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. On my cue again, and wait, he wasn't ready there. On my cue, here we go, and go.
What was it?
22.
Who wins that? Who fucking wins that? You was at 30. I was at fucking 18.
He was closer.
Were we going closest?
Because I asked if we were doing Price is Right rules.
I thought we were doing closest without going over. But
no, that's why I asked for Price is Right.
Like once he passes your time, I think you're out.
So it's him.
I think it would be him.
I asked if we were doing prices. That's Price is Right.
I think it's got to be in this kind of thing.
I think it's got to be closest, man. No?
Yeah. See, I was doing good, but
shit,
then
I'm out regardless, so you two motherfuckers argue about it yourself.
I was far away. Here, take it.
I was actually doing pretty good the first time, but then I got a glimpse of that monkey head up there, and that's what really, you know.
Monkey head freaked you out?
Yeah. Just kind of, you know. Jesus
Christ, I'm telling you. That's the best shot he could possibly give.
How about one more bet?
Oh, okay.
One more, and then we'll have him do some stand-up.
This is the real deal, me and Patrice.
Yeah.
Right? The real deal.
All right, what's the rules here?
Here's the money. Oh God, well, no, there's 10 in there.
Okay, keep it in there.
Whose is that? That's yours, I think.
No, okay, that's Patrice. He made his 10.
Yeah, that's Patrice. There's mine.
All right, what do we got?
All right. Now, obviously, I got to go over 10.
Well,
you
have
to. The guy seems to be... Now, based on research... 18 seems pretty good, but
are we gonna?
And he's working on. I'm gonna go with an even 20. We are going closest to the number. Doesn't matter if you go over or not.
All right.
If that seems to be the way.
I'm gonna go down.
Oh shit!
Wow. 15. This guy.
15.
He cannot. He struggled to 22. That
I
was
know,
pain and
I
suffering.
Know.
15.
Do we have
that
on video?
You got to take a big shit. You know you're doing it. Just can't come out. Yeah. Little turtle head poking out, but you just can't. That's what it feels like.
Too much going on.
You know, in my head.
He had to close his eyes that time.
He was
real Tai Chi on that shit right there. And that's it. That's as best as he got.
Yeah, it was.
15 seconds again.
All right.
People
all right.
saying best dead air ever. Ever.
All right, here it is. We're going to go now. Me and Patrice are in. Patrice is saying 15. I'm saying 20.
15.
All right, okay.
He's warming up. All right, we're gonna start this in 10 seconds, though.
Get
it all out there, Lewis.
Whatever you need to do.
There is nothing
all right,
to get
here we
out.
Go.
It's all right, in there.
You can
it's
count down.
All right,
3, 2.
And go.
It was like right between 15 and 20. Exactly. It was exactly between
15 and 20. We have to go again.
15 and 20.
We have to go again. I swear to God.
That was 17.5 seconds.
17.5.
Holy shit.
Damn.
This is science that we study.
Wow.
Cannot go past it. He's in deep shit now.
Oh, my God. I feel like Jerry Lewis on crack.
I don't know what to think now, though. All right. I got to bring it down a little bit.
The money's in.
I got to bring it down a little bit.
You guys should add to the pot, man.
I'm going
to
go.
Add to the pot. Come on. Throw a little more in there. Lewis, get it all out, bro. Get it all out.
What do you got in
there? Put a 20 and take 10 back. Just take,
all right.
Take 10 back.
Here we go. All right.
This is...
God damn.
This is
God.
Now.
All right.
Oh, he's boinging.
I'm going.
And right. You know what the funny thing is? When I go into clubs and I hear rap music, I end up doing it to the beat sometimes. All right. Music. I can't help it.
Here's what we got to do.
He's boinging, baby.
We got to flip a coin to see who's going to pick first, because that seems to be pretty important.
All right.
So, Opie, right. If you flip this quarter.
Hey, here we go.
I can't believe you're checking on this. Right? Who's calling it?
Tail.
Heads.
All right, go ahead.
Anthony's got the time.
All right. I'm saying 16 seconds.
16 seconds. Now, this is over the closest. Over
closest.
Closest.
Or, yeah, it doesn't matter.
That last one was dead center, man. I was ready to give Anthony the title.
It was totally tied.
21.
21.
Wow. All right, he's got some balls here.
He's getting tired.
I got
he's
some balls.
He's boinging me. He's tired in the Tourette's world.
All right, here we go. All right. I say 16.
16, you say 21.
21.
How much
21
is in the pot?
There's 40 bucks in here now.
All right, here we go.
One second.
All right.
He's getting
water.
Baby. He's getting water.
I'll join you in a
do
little
do your
sip.
Thing, man. This is me. All the Tourette's kids, the book, this is going to show that you have self-control.
That's
all
right.
Right.
This is for Little Twitching Timmy.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. What's the name of the book again?
Little Twitching Timmy, the Turtle with Tourette's. You can take a look at it at my website, laughterbylou.com.
Laughter by Lou?
Laughter by Lou. That's spelled L-O-U, laughterbylou.com.
I'm telling you, baby. Boing.
Come on.
Boing means victory, baby.
Oh,
close
man.
To bingo.
It's like you guys are talking about it so much. You got all these pictures on the wall.
Yeah.
It's like
that's what I'm banking on.
Anthony, you're so. Well, no, I think Anthony's not fucked. I think Patrice is fucked.
I think Patrice.
All right, here's the deal.
Right, here we go.
Anthony says he'll last 16 seconds. Patrice says he'll last 41 seconds.
21. Go ahead, get him, Tiger.
All right, here we go. I'm IQ. We're just waiting for the hand to hit six. Hit it.
Patrice wins!
Wow! What a day, baby!
God damn! You take it away, brother.
Fucking money, baby.
You, fair and square, legit. Wow. Wow. He was holding that in.
And just a little.
When it passed 16, I'm like,
good
damn,
job.
Come on.
Wait a minute, we got to share this, baby.
Mommy's
that's
so
it.
Proud, right?
Oh, wow.
That was, I think that was 26 seconds,
thanks,
if you're keeping track at home.
So
wow.
Go, man.
Dave, I'll buy a couple packs of cigarettes.
Do your thing.
Dave from Atlanta. Dave, what's going on?
Hey, man, I've been listening to the bit for 5 minutes, just turned on the radio. Well, what are you guys doing?
Oh, you're going to have to listen to the replay today.
Yeah, we're just betting.
And we're betting on how long this Tourette's guy could stay silent before he twitches.
Guys, call me Twitchels. It's actually funny because Nicole Richie.
Right now,
oh, really?
Yeah, I was on The Simple Life with Paris Hilton and Nicole Richie. And that was the whole and now the whole premise of the scene, you know, I was on the bus with them. They were on the Greyhound bus. And my Tourette's are acting up. And Nicole Richie jumps up on my lap, gives me a big hug, tries to calm me down, and calls me Twitchels. And she's the one that nicknamed me it. So I go by Twitchels, you know. Whenever I do stuff like this,
God bless him.
Yeah, God bless him.
God bless him. We can walk. We go all over the world making money.
Don't you feel a lot better about yourself when you like see this?
Hey. I feel a lot better about myself.
I got an idea. Lewis definitely should do a stand up. We got about 15 people in the studio, and I'm thinking, Anthony, that we should have a little tissue time. We get a girl to talk dirty.
Okay.
To Lewis, and we tie the two brand new bits together.
Certainly.
We need a girl that's really good at talking dirty and is able to do a little phone sex.
Can
I
tell you what type of women I like? Would that help?
Yeah, definitely.
Certainly.
Okay.
What do you...
Oh, right now?
Okay. Yeah, what do you dig on?
You know, for some reason, I don't know what it is, but it always gets to me. I like black women, and when they talk angry, It kind of, I don't know if it's a turn on, but I might.
No black women.
I don't know. I just always like
5 minutes. Sweetie, if you, I don't know what the fuck Tourette's is.
See, I love that.
But the next time you call me a nigga by mistake,
I know I got a cousin named Tourette's, but.
By the way.
I don't know what it means and shit.
Damn. Please, guys, realize that I was coaxed by my home dogs to do that. I was coaxed by them.
Oh, my God.
I'm going to walk out of the studio and get fucking shot.
Nah.
Or no, I won't.
Right.
No, you won't. We learned that.
I like that one.
All right, we need a girl that is good at talking dirty to call the show immediately. Could be best fit ever.
That one I've had since I was about 14 to jump a dick.
How about we get Lewis to do some stand-up, okay? You want the lights turned down a little bit?
What do
you...
Yeah, keep making more club atmosphere.
Here, turn that down a little bit.
There we go.
A little bit. And the children's book. Come on, we got to get the plugs out.
Oh, yeah. Well, basically, I just came out with a children's book a couple months ago called Little Twitching Timmy, The Turtle with Tourette's. And it's a fully color illustrated children's book. I wrote and illustrated it. Trafford is the publishing company that you guys can check it out at trafford.com or laughterbylou.com. Boing! And another.
Wow.
Or you could call it. You could order. It's a great book. Book, you know, if you want
you
order
should have
kids.
Him in plugging everybody's shit. Hey, this is Jim Norton. I'll be over at the Westbury Music Fair. It's Patrice O'Neal. I'll be at Caroline's next week.
Now, the thing, you guys got me so fucking worked up. When I do a show, I usually smoke a bunch of cigarettes, get in my zone. But now I've been, you know, you're a toy for 15 minutes, so it's...
Exactly.
So let's... I love it, though. I got to calm down, though.
How many minutes you want to do? A couple minutes?
I'll just do a few materials.
All right.
Whatever you want to do.
But, you know, usually what I say is, you know, people always ask me, they say, you know, what's Tourette's? What is...
Wait, are you starting your act?
Are you interrupting it?
I was going to...
I like this kid.
Fuck you, Obi. Fuck you. You motherfucker.
What's this world coming to?
You motherfucker. Oh, it's my disorder.
Are you starting? Are you interrupting?
I thought you said start the act, Spider. I thought you said start the act, Spider.
This is the act, God.
They're
going to give you the big intro and everything.
Man, turn on him, you bastard.
God damn.
Oh, my God.
These guys worked right into it, and it was so, spontaneous, and Opie just trampled him.
I'm sorry.
I fucking
do it again.
All right, here we go.
All right,
it's Lewis the comic with Tourette's. Everybody.
All right, thank you. Thanks, guys. You know what I was, what I was starting to say was, you know, people always ask me, you know, what's Tourette's like, and you know, what is it? And I always, you know, start off. I want to explain what Tourette's is, and in a nutshell, basically, it's this disorder that causes people to twitch, grunt, curse, and they can't control it. In my case, I have one of my big ones is where I constantly jerk my head back and forth. That's one that I do every so often, and when I do that. What are you pointing to?
Watching TV.
So basically, I'm a Japanese tourist worst nightmare. But besides the point, I have Tourette's.
I'm sorry, we don't want you going away in an ambulance, making an ambulance sound yourself.
Yeah, you almost cracked your head on the TV, so we all got nervous.
Thank you, guys.
Sorry, we were worried about your safety. We weren't ready to laugh there because we thought you were going to crack your skull.
Well, thank you for caring. Woo! Fuck you.
Ambulance is here.
For those of you who just
leading.
All right, here we go. Back to Lewis the comic with Tourette's, everyone.
Oh, shit.
All right. Okay, I'm good now. I'm good. You know, for those of you just tuning in, if you missed it, you know, one of my tics that I like the most is the tic where I'm raising my hand up and down constantly in the air and I just can't control it, which fucks me out of going to auctions. I could never go there. So, laugh.
But we heard that one.
I know, for those who just tuning in.
All right.
Oh, my God.
Probably.
You guys fucked me up today.
Oh, my God.
You guys.
Oh, my God. That's actually him. That's him.
Look, I don't look. You guys have got me so worked up. I don't want to do this. You guys got me so worked up. What I do want to do is I want to ask you. Ask me anything you want. You know, I want to talk to you about it because the reason why I'm doing this, I want to spread awareness. I want to spread awareness, guys. You know.
Yeah, someone wants to know if your children's book is available on tape.
Oh my God, you just reminded me. They want me to do an audio version of
yes, book on tape.
See, yeah. Jane. Whore. What? Jane's a whore.
Little twitching Timmy was just as normal as you. Fuck off.
Ow. Ow. Oh, it hurts. It hurts.
There's so many people calling right now. We can't get the lines free. We're trying to get the lines free so a girl calls in to do the phone sex
thing. Oh, my God, I can't wait. And just to let you know, there's not a lot of people who have Tourette's.
Wow, that's some sound.
Meet George Jetson. Fuck.
Hi, you know, I met a man on the street the other day. He said he hadn't had a bite in weeks. What'd you do?
That's the smartest thing I've ever heard.
I'm going to go home and eat a raw cookie dough while watching Golden Girl reruns right now. You make me hate myself.
No.
But I love you guys. It's cool. But I was saying, there's only one famous person that, to my knowledge, other than Ned Campbell's brother, which really isn't famous, that has Tourette's. You guys know the Philadelphia Phillies. I don't know if you know, 1993, around there, a player by the name of Jim Eisenreich. He went to the World Series with them. He had Tourette's, and that's why I wear my Phillies cap wherever I go. It's kind of like a reminder of how fucked up I am.
Wow. Look at you are exhausted. You are exhausted.
You're right, Louis?
Oh no, I have fun with this. It takes a lot out of me.
It just looks exhausted.
Yeah, the next time we do some kind of live event, you gotta be there, man.
God bless you, man. I'll be more than happy to show up. Thank you.
You are like constantly working.
But please make this guy some type of celebrity, please.
Absolutely.
Can you please?
Doesn't it seem like it's constantly like you're jogging all the time?
He can't shut up. If he does not stop, he's going to do it. So he has to.
Do you twitch in your sleep?
Go.
You know what? That is a funny thing. I never knew, so I decided to tape myself one night. And, you know, this is a true story. I wasn't ticking throughout the whole night. And the tape only lasted like two hours or so. Yeah. So I could have. But what I started to feel myself while I'm sleeping, and I started to do this. Going up and down, and I didn't know if that was a tick or if I was just in a dream, but to my knowledge, I never really know if I'm actually...
You don't make sounds or anything?
I'm sleeping, I don't know. I wouldn't know. But
on the tape, you didn't make any sounds?
No, just like when you turn over. Hey,
and
like
how do you get to sleep?
You know what? One of the things that I always say is if my tics are so bad, the one thing I like to do... I like to...
So, maybe it's dice with Tourette's. I'm at the bank. And it's chicks online at the beginning.
I sound like an old Jewish guy with
Henry. Here I am. So I'm banging this broad in the ass, and she's like, a gig! Oh, a drama! Oh, Anthony the Jetson sound, please! Hickory dickory dog, this chick... Jack be nimble, Jack be quick! Oh!
Hello, sir. Welcome to McDonald's. What can I take your order?
Oh, wow. Dennis from Whackbag. This guy sounds like a lost member of the Three Stooges.
Oh, you know, talking about...
I think you scared the women away because they're not calling for the phone sex thing.
Oh, you know what was funny? Talk about the simple life. A few months after that, Nicole Richie was on Letterman, and she talked about me on Letterman about having Tourette's. She didn't remember my name, but she just referred to me as Twitchels.
Bitch.
And I thought, So anyway. I saw her 2 weeks ago.
He has complete access to all his noises that he can do on purpose and by mistake.
A repertoire.
So he could just go bruh and bruh at the same time. He can't control it and he controls it at the same time.
Patrice, it was funny because she did a book signing in New York 2 weeks. I can't look at you now. She did a book signing.
What you call me?
2 weeks ago.
Did a book signing.
I just want to die. So 2 weeks ago, Nicole Richie did a book signing at Virgin Megastore, and I went to go see her, not only to get a copy of hers, but to give her a copy of mine.
But to continue your stalking of her, obviously.
The first time I saw her since we did it a year ago.
Yeah.
Shot the episode. Yeah. Anyway, so what we did was, so I'm so fucking nervous now. Okay. So she jumped up and she yelled, Twitchell. She remembered me instantly, gave me a big hug, and that's a good feeling that people remember me, but you know what the whole point is? You know, I'm living my life. I'm doing what I have to do. And anyone who has Tourette syndrome, they shouldn't, you know, go into studios and try to be quiet for 15, 20 seconds.
They
really should just have fun and try to do whatever they want to do. You know, my teacher, when I was in about 7th, 8th grade, looked at me, did not believe.
That's just the, I have gotta keep
the
talking.
Next time he's here, this is the bet, not silence. It's how many within a span of, you keep track, somebody keeps track.
Oh, that's a good one.
Within a span of 5 minutes of him talking.
Wow.
Do me a favor. Don't remind me about that, because I don't want to be thinking about it. So it's fair. Don't remind me that you're going to do that.
Right. It wouldn't matter anyway, motherfucker.
No.
As you try to concentrate. And anyway, when I was a teacher, he wants to be doing it now. But that's why he's telling a heartfelt story. When I was a child, someone called me,
my teacher in 7th grade, basically, she told me, she said, listen, Louis, you cut it out. And I was having an outburst. And she looked at me and said, you don't have Tourette's. You don't have it. It's made up. It's a lie. And that's why I'm trying to, you know, I'm not getting all mushy, but that's why I'm trying to spread awareness, because people still don't believe. It's you know, not all people, but most people find it hard to believe that it's a real disorder.
Right.
And it is a neurological disorder. And, you know, that's why I'm writing this book. That's why I'm trying to get the word out there. And I've actually finished a screenplay, which I haven't,
It's an unfair
disease. I have some
disease.
People attached to it, and I want to spread the word.
It's an unfair disease because you can't have... it's like stuttering. You just can't have sympathy for it. But I'm sure it's something we don't want to
I never win staring.
All right, listen. We got 20 seconds left in the show. So, Louis, we got to get all the plugs in. How do they get the children's book?
Basically, you can order Little Twitching Timmy, the Turtle with Tourette's, through my website, laughterbylou.com. That's laughterbylou.com. Or trafford.com, or by calling the toll-free number, 888-232-4444.
I was wondering where the sound was during the plug.
Patrice O'Neill.
I'm here, motherfucker.
We'll see you tomorrow.
This concludes our podcast day. The Jim Anthony Show.